Hello. It's me, Brent Carter. The current reigning Day of Birth Bonanza champion. And undefeated. Three-time Day of Birth Bonanza champion. So it's that time of year again. And I thought, you know, since I won Day of Birth Bonanza 1 and Day of Birth Bonanza 2 and last year Day of Birth Bonanza 3, I figured that, you know, it's probably about time for somebody else to get a shot at this. It's not fair that I just, you know, keep beating everyone. That's, you know, it's a bit too one-sided. So I am relinquishing my title as Day of Birth Bonanza champion. There will be a brand new Day of Birth Bonanza champion after this episode that you're watching. So good luck to everyone involved, apart from Tom. Fuck Tom. And I might come back for my, I'm retired. Maybe, I don't know. Enjoy the show.
You're listening to the SWN podcast.
And this is SWN.
Welcome to SWN.
Skull! Skull! Skull!
This is SWN.
And this is the Scottish Wrestling Network.
Where Scottish wrestling lives, I guess. Is that a tagline? I guess. I don't know.
Hello. Right. Everyone's consented. We're all
yes,
in.
Absolutely.
Consent before we do a group activity. Welcome to the SWM podcast. It is the annual Day of Birth Bonanza. I'm very excited to. This is actually one of the most stressful bonanzas to try and organise because everyone's busy. There's a clash at the castle. It just happened this past weekend, so I was trying to organise a date and time and everyone to come in. But we're here. We're here for the Day of Birth Bonanza. Fourth time of in as many years as the fourth anniversary of the podcast has happened. It's been and gone. It went out 2 weeks ago with Judas Grey, if you're on the main timeline. But here we are on the 17th of June. So with that being said, there is no trophy at the moment because I ordered it a week ago and it has not arrived. So if you're watching this as it happens, I don't have it in my possession. But if you're watching this episode on July 2nd, there'll probably be a little video package at the start where I show off the trophy. And what everyone is vying for. On this episode, we're joined by five competitors. In his absence, Brent Carter has decided to not return for this year. The three-time Day of Birth Bonanza winner, he is not returning. He's decided to relinquish and let somebody else try and take that crown as Day of Birth Bonanza champion. We'll probably hear a statement from him in a little bit. So yeah, five rounds. Lots of questions, 89 points on offer. We'll see who does it. Let's introduce everyone that's in it. I should have really thought of an intro before I actually did this episode, but you know, it took me, I had to finish writing my round this morning, and then everyone else's had to copy and paste. Joining me on this Day of Birth Bonanza this year as returning guests to the show, to my right, left on screen, is the owner and promoter of Bleeding Gums Wrestling. He is just off a massive weekend that saw him at Clash at the Castle and promoting his own show, along with W3L and Valor at Backlash, which sounded like it was absolute madness. Thank you for joining us, Andrew Crammond. Welcome.
Thanks for having me. Cheers.
I'm very excited to have you. I was kind of shocked to have you go, I'll do a quiz. So I'm glad that...
As long as it's wrestling or like movie questions, fuck aye, let's go.
You're in the right place then. One round might... irritate you, but generally it's wrestling and movie related. To my right on screen, left somewhere, is the current, I think he's done two quizzes and he has landed last on both of them. And I even got Gaz Williams in for an episode, hoping that he would to give Tom a chance. And Gaz was really good, to be honest. It was a bit of a shocker. Joining us is Fallen God, Tom Atlas.
Right, Billy, we've been here before, right? But here's the thing. This is now a win-win situation. Because I either retain my wooden spoon or I walk away with this championship. And I guarantee that there is no in-between. Are you understood?
We're understood, and I haven't told everyone else, but we made an agreement on the last episode on camera that because you're so terrible at quizzes, I don't know if you're playing the long con. It could be the long con here that I'm really stupid. He gets a 3-point head start, but there is 20 points on offer in the first round, so that could
he
disappear.
Get deducted
in
3 points for wearing his dad's massive headphones. What are those things, kids?
He's a Twitch streamer now. He's on the Twitch.
Look,
an affiliate.
It has color, yeah, right? Okay, we're good.
So to my bottom, I need to finish that sentence really quickly. To my bottom right, left on screen, it's not a pirate. It is FCW podcast co-host. We can check out the FCW podcast on all our stations on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, all that. It is Patrick Patierski.
Hello.
Sans bucket hat.
Yes. Yes, but I do have a rather nifty eye patch thanks
Yar.
To Mr. Samuel from the Red Gate. But yeah, I mean, I'm not missing this though. This is part of my recovery, is getting involved in a quiz with
the rehab.
So thank you for having me. Yeah.
Directly below me on screen is just fresh off download, so that may hamper her chances. You've heard her voice already, mocking Tom Atlas, which I think will be a very common occurrence in this next hour or so. We're joined by the Dynamite, current FCW Women's Champion, Brody Adler. Welcome back.
Thank you.
So, you've been on
I'm
this
so
before.
I'm so tired.
You've been on this before. You and Tom have been on the pot on the Dear Birth Bonanza before. It usually ends up in an argument some point during, so.
Yeah, because, I never get to win. So, and I think you should just let me win, personally, because.
Well, I'm not going to lie to you. When I was polling, as in I asked people who were asking the questions, when I told you who was going to be on this, you're the favourite. You're the favourite to win. So, take that for you, Will. And finally, bottom left, right, the one with the mask, is a returning guest. First come on the podcast this season, and now he's back on. So I think that's probably the quickest I've went from having someone on the podcast and then returning as a second time. It is the current FCW Junior Heavyweight Champion. All the belts, all the championships. I love championships on this podcast. There's so many this season. It's Spike Tierney. Welcome back.
Thanks for having us.
So that's many few words. So we've got five rounds of quizzing. They've been curated and done by a many smattering of wrestlers, which I'll introduce as we're going along who did the rounds. Everyone ready just to get on with it? Let's get
go.
Started.
Yeah.
Cool. Right. Last year, I got really into titling the rounds. I'll be honest, I got lazy with it this year, so I haven't really done that. So the first round's me. I did the first one, and I called it Easing You In. Cool. I did leave it on for later on in the pod. Before I got people to do rounds for me, it was going to be round four, because I was going to call it round four play, and then make it all dirty.
Hey.
But we have not done that. We have just easing you in, nice, delicate questions, because other rounds are not very delicate at all. So, there's 10 questions, 10 points, 20 points on offer. First one, all wrestling. First question. Who did Drew McIntyre defeat to become the WWE Intercontinental Champion? So we'll get the questions, and then we'll get the answers afterwards, once I've done the 10 questions.
When?
He's only been champion once.
This first title.
And before I started watching.
That's scary. That's terrifying. Absolutely terrifying.
We're also going on an honor system for the points. Because previous years, I think Brody was the last year that I actually did the tallying myself, and it was a disaster. So we're just trusting that you tell me that you got it right. And
oh, yeah.
Well, with people like Tom Atlas and his massive lugs, like, seriously.
Oh, yeah, if he's first after this round, there will be an inquiry. Question, everyone happy with that one? Everyone? Cool.
Yes.
Question two, how many times has Nikki Cross / Ash been tag team champion in WWE?
Oh.
You get a bonus point if you name her tag team partners.
Oh.
Tag team champion.
So that's how many times has Nikki Cross / Ash been tag team champion in WWE? Bonus point for naming her tag team partners.
Do you get half a point for naming one?
Shop Top.
No.
You have to name all of our tag team partners for the bonus.
Look, I'd rather ask the question to get out in the air just to check. You know.
There's no auxiliary points this year. It's the bonus points I have written down, and that's it. That's I'm not giving points for fun facts this year.
Ah, Billy's foot is down this year. Down. Yes, man.
To be honest, last year I still wake up in a cold sweat that I told quite big time YouTuber Alex Webb to fuck off for asking for bonus questions. That I feel
good.
Like I just need to,
good,
I need
Billy,
to draw that line now.
I like a strict quizmaster. Rate it highly. Yes.
Question three: who did Gallus defeat to win the NXT UK Tag Team Championships?
Oh, yes. I think
it was. Like I said, most of mine are, pretty much all mine are very recent. They're all Scottish based.
I was going to say that and I was like, oh dear. you're going to WWE in like the 80s, it'd be all right. But...
I thought this might be, but this is probably the only time that Tom has a chance. Because,
I'm fucked already. There's no shot.
So that was, who did Gallus defeat to win the NXT UK Tag Team Championships? All good. Moving on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Question four: what was Piper Niven's name while teaming with Eva Marie?
Oh. Wait. Yeah.
So that was what was Piper Niven's name while teaming with Eva Marie?
Hard times.
Question
five. Oh. There was something fucking stupid, wasn't it?
Yep.
I'll
think about it.
Question five. For 1 point, name both members of WWE's Highlanders team.
Oh, yes.
Both past guests on the podcast. Don't like to mention it.
Do we get bonus points if we just like list the tag team of the Lowlanders?
No bonus points.
Ah.
we've just discussed this. No
I
bonus
know,
points.
But... I'm going to ask again and again anyway.
I saw the Highlanders at a house show once and it was fucking great. This would have been in like 2006 or something.
I was at Aberdeen.
Yeah,
I think you were at night two and I was at night one.
Yeah, I think we talked about that before, yeah. My main event was RKO, Rated RKO and Umaga versus DX and Cena. I got back the Highlanders, man. That's why I was there.
So was I. My event was Rated RKO DX. Incredible. So that was named both members of WWE's Highlanders tag team. I will take just both first names if you somehow blank on the surname. Question six. Who did Kaylee Ray defeat to become NXT UK Women's Champion?
Oh, it was somebody good.
Oh, they were the champions, so generally that's how it works.
I mean, not necessarily, Billy. Not necessarily.
How dare you slag off NXT UK, that prestigious brand?
I'm not slagging off NXT UK, I'm just not naming. Tom. I don't even know if you've ever been a champion, I'm just here to rag on Tom, to be honest.
No, I've not been, no.
Oh, darling, maybe you should change that Zoom name.
NXT UK is out my wheelhouse. I don't watch any NXT UK.
Nobody did.
I never watched it, genuinely.
Who did Kaylee? So that's question six. Who did Kaylee Ray defeat to become NXT UK Women's Champion? Well, you're not going to like the next question then. Question seven. Joe Coffey main evented the first NXT UK takeover in 2019. Who did he face?
Oh, Yeah.
I might have seen that.
The first NXT UK takeover.
Yep.
Was it? No.
So it was Blackpool. That helps.
Lose, Billy.
That's Joe Coffey main event at the first NXT UK takeover in 2019. Who did he face? Question 8, which I think Patrick's going to know the answer to if from our brief conversation from that moment before. Rowdy Roddy Piper has held one tag team championship in WWE. Who is his tag team partner?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I do know the answer.
Was that, oh, yeah, a hint? Or...
maybe, I don't know.
So that was Rowdy Roddy Piper has held one tag team championship in WWE. Who was his tag team partner? Question 9. All good?
Yeah.
Question 9. Grado appeared at AEW All in the countdown portion of the event. What is his character's name in Scott Squad?
See.
That is, Grado appeared at AEW All in the countdown portion of the event. What is his character's name in Scott Squad?
His full name or just his first name?
If you get his first name, I'll accept it.
I think I've got his first name. I've never watched Scott Squad. So,
if you get his first name, I'll take it.
I've also never watched Scott Squad.
I binged it during my 5 o'clock wake ups with the boy. So I just watched on iPlayer.
The boy.
I feel like it's weird. I shouldn't name him on the podcast for some reason. I feel like
I've seen like one clip of when I'm sure he stops like a Rangers supporters bus or something, but then he like obviously should arrest them because they're drinking and all of that. They just like lets him get away with it. I think that's like the one bit I've seen.
And the final question of this round is for a maximum of 9 points.
Jesus.
Drew Galloway was inducted. Yeah, but it's a terrible question for you. Drew Galloway was inducted into the Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame for Scotland during Clash at the Castle week. Name any other inductee.
Oh.
Any other inductee.
But for 9 points. Not any other, but 9 others.
Well, if you get a point for each, you name.
Scotland's Hall of Fame or UK Hall of Fame?
The Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame for Scotland is the official title for it.
Okay.
Cool.
I'm just going to start listing off random names and hope one fucking sticks. That's probably the best shot I've got here.
So that is Drew Galloway was inducted into the Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame for Scotland during Clash at the Castle week. Name any other inductee. My site stats went through the roof because I'm the only place that's got it collated as who's in the Hall of Fame. I had a great week looking at my site stats. Fantastic. So that's it. First round. First round in the bag.
In the books.
Oh, fucking hell. This is not going to go well.
Out of sight.
Everyone feeling good about that round?
Fuck no.
Okay. Nope. Okay. Okay. I mean, it was the easiest one, so,
If this is the easiest one, I might as well just leave.
we have an easier round if you like movies, but this is probably the easiest wrestling round you're going to get.
I don't watch movies. Really.
Oh, well, yeah. then you're fucked in general.
Yeah, Spike famously doesn't watch movies.
So this whole DE takeover that we planned is probably out the window now, yeah.
Yeah, oh well. We've got a kebab beside us. I'm fine with that.
Yeah.
So the answers. Let's get through that.
Oh yeah.
Question 1: Who did Drew McIntyre defeat to become the WWE Intercontinental Champion? I want to throw in the answer.
I said Ziggler.
I said Ziggler as well.
I said John Morrison.
Patrick's correct. It is John Morrison.
Oh boo.
Question 2, how many times has Nikki Cross / Ash been tag team champion in WWE?
About twice.
Yeah, same, twice.
Twice.
I put 3.
Spike's correct, 3 times.
Well done, Spike.
Why did we need to have a wrestling round? I suck at wrestling stuff.
do you get any points for naming the partners, even if you get the number of title reigns wrong?
You do, you get 1 point.
To Bliss and Rhea Ripley.
Yep, Alexa Bliss twice and Rhea Ripley once. So what
the fuck did Nikki team with Rhea?
That was right about the time she won Money in the Bank.
Yeah, that was not in my brain at all.
And the
I've got Alexa Bliss written down. Do I get a point, or is
you
that...
get a point? You get a point for three times. You get a point for Alexa Bliss, and you get a point for Rhea Ripley.
Okay, you get a point for effort.
That's
fair. Look, so if we got points for effort, I'd probably won last year, but no, we don't get points for effort.
Yeah, but if I ask, I might get them. Like, you're Tom, you're not getting, you ain't get shit, bro.
No bonus points. I am being, no auxiliary points outside of what I've written down. I am being strict this year.
Yes.
Question three. Who did Gallus defeat to win the NXT UK Tag Team Championships?
I put Pretty Deadly
as well.
Shit.
The answer is Flash Morgan Webster and Mark Andrews.
Oh, subculture. Shit.
No boys.
I'm not having fun.
Oh, would you look at four. That? It's my bedtime.
I'm looking at the time. It is my bedtime. But we're gonna carry on. Question four. What was Piper Niven's name while teaming with Eva Marie?
Doudrop. I know that one.
I got this right. I was shocked.
Well done.
Doudrop.
Out of nowhere. Doudrop.
Question five.
Doudrop, that one almost.
Question five. Name both members of WWE's Highlanders tag team.
Robbie and Rory.
There we go. Robbie and Rory. Anyone want to throw in the last name as well?
McAllister.
There we go. Robbie and Rory McAllister.
So is that 2 points for the second name? Or no?
No, 1 point. If you got you said Rory and Robbie, you've got a point. But if you said McAllister as well, you've
just got chance of my luck there.
Fair, that's fair. Go for it. Rory's gonna do it every question and every round, so that's fair. Both past guests on the podcast, for everyone to go check their archives. We have questions and answers with them. Or an interview. That's probably a better way to say it. Question six. Who did Kaylee Ray defeat to become the NXT UK Women's Champion? Tom?
Was it Toni Storm?
It was Toni Storm.
Yes. Nice.
I got a correct answer. I'm happy. I can die happy.
You've got 4 points now, then.
You have really low expectations for life, Tom. It makes me really depressed.
Sorry. I don't think I've got a choice right now.
Question,
you get one of those.
he's spunked it on the first question, first round. That's a shame. Joe Coffey made event at the first NXT UK takeover in 2019. Who did he face?
Tyler Bate.
Rich.
Pete Dunne.
It's Pete Dunne.
Same thing.
There's no bonus point, but who debuted after the match?
Gunther. Walter.
There's no bonus point. Yeah. That's just a fun fact.
You're better than I expected. Pretty shocking, actually.
Well, I mean, who knows? By the time we get to the fifth round, we'll probably all fall out by then, anyway. Question eight. Rowdy Roddy Piper has held one tag team championship at WWE. Who is his tag team partner?
Was it the British Bulldog? Because I'm looking at all my pop videos to get Rick answers
Flair.
Here.
It was the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
It was Ric Flair.
I don't have a
Ric
Flair pop
vinyl
though.
Was that Taboo Tuesday?
it was their Tuesday or Cyber Sunday, but it was 2006.
Yeah, one of them.
So I was on the same, looking at the pops. And...
Because they thought it was going to be Dusty Rhodes, but everyone voted for Piper.
That's not
going to
help me.
Because
2006?
Yeah, bro.
Right. No. Had the titles for like 2 weeks, and then Rated RKO, like, killed Piper, and then Piper got a medical check afterwards and found out he had cancer. That was a bit of a whirlwind of a...
Oh, right.
So the WWE fans voting for Piper saved his life by a few years. So, well done everyone that had a computer in 2006.
Question nine. Grado appeared at AEW All In the countdown portion of the event. What is the character's name in Scott Squad?
Is his name...
PC Hugh McCurdy.
PC Hugh McCurdy.
Oh my god!
Nice. I just put his TNA name of Odark the Great just for a laugh.
I just put Dick in.
I mean, there probably was a character in Scott Squad at that point. Question 10, the big one. Drew Galloway was inducted into the Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame for Scotland during Class at the Castle Week. Name any other inductee, point for each, So I'll go through the list. I'll go. He's not in it. I'll go through the list.
Surprising.
Nope. The list is Drew McDonald's there. So Drew McDonald, George Kidd, Andy Robin, Frank Chick McCullen. Cullen. Frank Chick Cullen, not McCullen. Bill Ross, Chick Pervy, Jim McKenzie, Ian Campbell, Rusty Blair.
Nate Charles.
No, fuck that. I even wrote down Piper. I thought they might have done that as a comedy one.
Yeah.
I wrote Drew McIntyre. Did I get a point for that? Because technically, he's there.
Well, technically, that was the first name I said in the question, so no. And it's Galloway on the induction as well. So,
oh.
No. So dice.
I mean, I was just trying to maintain kayfabe, Billy, but whatever.
Okay, see? Alex Webb, calm down.
Kick him. Kick him from the shot.
So it's 10 questions. How's everyone done?
Amazing.
I got nine. Yeah.
Right, hang on, I'll go around the room. I'll do it in alphabetical order so I get it. Andrew, how many points?
Five. Yep.
Brody.
I don't think it's fair to everyone else that I go next because they might be embarrassed because of how good I am.
Four.
I got three.
Three. Of 20 points.
Oh my God, no, I did. Sorry, I got three. Sorry.
Patrick Kuski.
I got seven.
Whoa. Spike.
Nine.
Nice.
Oh, wow.
What? No, you didn't.
And I did. Tom.
So you're working.
Tom got four.
Sweet, Tom got one. That's what we're saying. Tom got
no,
one.
No, I now have seven because I got four correct answers in this round. Thank you, Patrick.
So after one round with a head start, he's in second place. So
you better have a round on Pokemon, Billy. I'm not having him win over me.
So you're happy with the first round? That was quite nice and easy into the concept.
Yeah, I enjoyed that.
Yeah. That's patronizing.
Well, next up is the guest host for this round is coming into the chat now. We're coming into the Zoom room.
Oh
shit.
Is it my friend?
It is. Shit. Waiting for his video to appear. asking him to unmute. This is
a psych and it's someone who's not Ian Skinner, I'm leaving.
Right, so just before anything starts, should I go hop in the fridge?
Oh, hell yeah.
Hello.
You just rolled my roast card, cunts. Let's have a look at this lineup here. Brody Adler, wow. Wow, if Brody Adler's here, who's going to pierce a four-year-old girl's ears without her consent, huh? They say if you say Dynamite Brody Adler three times in the mirror, she'll actually blow up your DMs. And before you ask, Brody, no, I don't want a Metallica t-shirt. Thank you. Oh, look at that. It's Spike Tierney. Don't worry. I'll make sure these roasts are supercharged for you.
Oh, throwback.
Spike, one question for you. What does the element of change mean? How about you perform the element of surprise and update your social media? It's been a while. No word of a lie, actually, Spike, in all seriousness. I actually thought you were Billy under a mask for a very long time. You are the reason that there is, or used to be, a mask mandate. Oh, and speaking of mandate, Tom Atlas is here. Wow. Tom Atlas, who recently realized that if you put your hood up, people might mistake you for the protagonist of, like, a cringy 2000s PS3 game. What's your next nickname? The Prototype?
Yes, absolutely.
By the way, Tom, this isn't a roast, but the last time you tweeted was about this quiz 2 years ago when I was still on it. You should fix that. Oh, Andrew Crammond. Nice to meet you. I'm Ian Skinner. Cool guy and lots of friends. Andrew Crammond, for those who don't know, actually runs Leading Gums Wrestling in Scotland. Deathmatch. More like my name, Jeff Match. Hey, Andrew, if the gums are bleeding, how about you use some dental floss? Oh, there's Patrick. Patrick, you know, I'd love to do a podcast about Final Destination. I have such a fascination about it, I could speak about it for hours. Yeah, you've got a similar thing. You like to talk about your niche interest on a podcast as well. There's not much else I could find about you online. However, in other news, The Quiet Place is getting a video game. So you may be able to relate to that. And last but not least, Billy.
Hang on.
Billy, where do we start? Billy, you represent Scottish wrestling for a lot of people, which is it's on point because you are the AI result of wrestling fan in ChatGPT. A man who's got so many belts behind him, yet I can vividly imagine you running across the dance floor of a wedding with your trousers around your ankles.
Done that.
But yeah, I'm glad to be here, Billy, and I'm glad you've reduced the numbers of attendance for the quiz, mainly because I don't have to start taking ADHD medication again just to listen to this episode. But how about we get into the Ian Skinner round, the round that is only for me. If you get more than 50% in this round, you are definitely cheating. Question one. What is the name of Stone Cold Steve Austin's cat? Or as I like to call him, Steve. Once again, what is the name of Steve Austin's cat? That's been enough time. Question two. Name all four members of CPF. Close personal friends.
Wait. I think math is it.
Once again, that question is, name all four members of CPF, close personal friends. You only get the point, the singular point, if you get all of them.
Are these your friends? Because I don't think you've got four.
I'm a cool guy with lots of friends.
I'm sure.
Do you need surname, first name and last name, or just all last names?
Tom, you suck up! Hey, just write the damn names!
Tom, how about you try to do whatever answer you think suits?
Sounds good to me.
Question three. Finish the line from Blank Atlas song's Connections. Oh yeah, baby, show me those enormous... Once again, that question was, finish the line from the song Connections by Blank Atlas. Oh yeah, baby, show me those enormous... Question four, In Euphoria by Kendrick Lamar. What does Kendrick have in his house like Joe? Once again, in the song Euphoria by Kendrick Lamar, what does Kendrick have in his house like Joe? Also, just a quick one on this one. I will not accept any skips or passes or don't knows on this. I want legitimate guesses, okay? This is all about effort, okay? You can't just blow a spot and go, oh, can we try again? I want 100% effort. Next question. Who sings Ian Skinner's theme song, Hot Dog Boss, by Shotty Horror?
Oh, my God. I need to go home.
It's all a deep cut. Once again, who sings Ian Skinner's theme song, Hot Dog Boss, by Shotty Horror? This one's for Billy and a couple people. What does the Wrestling Review podcast claim Mean Gene Oakland's favorite hobby to be? Once again, what does the Wrestling Review podcast claim Mean Gene Oakland's favorite hobby to be? Favorite hobby, pastime, so on, so forth. The next question. Who is the most recent winner of the Young Lions Cup?
Shikara Young Lions Cup.
I mean, if you want to put the Shikara Young Lions Cup, we get bonus points. I'll do some research on that one. However, it is the New Japan Young Lions Cup.
Ah, okay.
I don't think we're allowed to talk about Shikara anymore.
Fair enough.
Once again, who's the most recent winner of the Young Lions Cup? Of whichever variety. next up, what pro wrestling move did the Power Rangers use to defeat Goldar in the 2017 Power Rangers movie? Once again, what pro wrestling move did the Power Rangers use to defeat Goldar in the Power Rangers movie 2017? This one's just for me. This one is just for me. But I would love to hear your guesses. What popular character did Mark Bonanno portray in the most recent episode of the most upsetting guessing game?
This is June 17th for anyone else that's playing along.
Yeah, if you're playing along at home, I'd love if you got this. What popular... Because I don't think you could search this up either. I think that you would have to have watched it. What popular character did Mark Bonanno portray in the most recent episode of the most upsetting guessing game? By the way, not wrestling related. It is very much open goal. You can put in a wrestler if you want. It will be incorrect. Or not. Who knows? Last question. Once again, you need to get all of them. Who are the current Sovereign Pro Wrestling champions? Once again, who are all the current Sovereign Pro Wrestling champions? Because
So that's Cup, Commonwealth, and Heavyweight. Yeah.
I mean, if the Cup's relevant, I think the last time, I'm trying to remember the last time it was on. But yeah, whichever categories. Let me tell you. Here's the feeling. There's four categories that I'm classifying as championships.
Okay.
Four categories that I'm classifying as championships. I'll give you a little bit longer for this one before we go down to the spicy extra bonus question that Billy. Oh, I mean, he's aware of what the bonus question is.
Mr. Skinner, what was question eight?
Question eight. What popular character did Mark Bonanno portray in the most recent episode of the most upsetting guessing game?
Oh shit! What was question nine then?
Was that not question nine? Question eight was the Power Ranger one, though.
Oh yeah, that one. Patrick. Listen, I didn't number my questions. Okay, I just knew I had to put 11 down.
Right, so surely you could tell me what 8 is then.
Well, yeah, Patrick just did.
I wasn't listening to Patrick.
My PA. Billy, give him 2 points.
No bonuses. I don't
care. It's my round. Give Patrick 2 points.
Okay, I'll lay it down.
Listen, because I feel like if the final comes down to like a 2-point lead from Patrick, okay? Listen, he's already handicapped, okay? Let's just like even the odds a little bit.
So when I get the question, or...
I'll do it. Brody, what wrestling move did the Power Rangers use to destroy Goldar in the 2017 Power Rangers movie?
Thank you.
Which was a terrible film.
Oh, it was. It was shit.
You watch your fucking tone, okay? because the extra bonus question here is, what film has Billy not seen, which still upsets me? Not the film, the fact that he's not seen it.
I still have not seen it.
It's fucking terrible. Hey, you'll have to listen to the Ian Skinner episode of the podcast, which I imagine would have been, what's the word, like, valid? I didn't go to school. What's the, like, required reading?
Awful.
For doing this? Huh?
How famous is this film? Like, I'm trying to guess for what it is.
It's quite famous, and you probably think I would have seen it.
Okay. A film or a series of films?
Oh, a film.
A singular film.
Okay.
Yes. Came out 2022.
Okay.
That was fairly big.
I'm at the point now, I'm just not going to watch it. Just to spite Ian. So...
I do most things.
Oh, I'm not going to have a good time in spite of you. Go fuck yourself, Billy. This is a non-canon episode. I can swear. I can be a dick.
Not
the fucking the ending. You caught the bait, bitch.
I am never DMing you again, bitch.
We'll wait till 3 a.m. tonight, then. Oh, I don't know what would happen at 3 a.m. tonight.
I do.
This is weird. I don't like this anymore. Yeah, before we proceed to the answers, anyone have any final questions?
Yeah, I do. If a giraffe was to wear a bow tie, would he wear it at the top of his neck, the middle, or the bottom?
Depends. Where's his shirt end?
Why does that matter? Like, what if he's not wearing a shirt?
Well, because that's where the bow tie goes. Like, if you don't know where his collar is, how do you know where the bow tie, like, the lapels go over?
He makes a good point.
That's a good point.
Yeah. Don't make me.
Oh, I get why it's Patrick with a Y now, because he's missing an eye.
I'm sorry, Patrick.
Let me just add that to the
the burn list.
There we go. That'll go in the cringe compilation. Tom, put your glasses back on. You look weird. Okay. The answer to question one: what is the name of Steve's cat?
Poncho.
Yeah.
Oh, it is as well.
I know a wrestling question.
Okay. Spike, what did you get? You look disappointed.
I didn't write anything.
Well, make a guess now.
Patrick's eye patch.
You heard the answer. You heard the answer like previously, like 30 seconds before. And okay, cool, nice, brilliant. I see we were all taking notes. Thank you. Who can name me all four members of CPF? Tom Atlas, go.
Joe Lando, Danny Black, Callum Newman, Maverick Mayhew.
Holy shit.
I got Huey, Louie, Dewey, and Gooey. Does that count?
Billy, deduct a point.
I'm actually going to beat Roddy Adler.
Billy, give me 10 points.
I mean, you'd probably still beat Tom.
Yeah, you probably
this round.
Okay, Billy, take my 10 points away.
Okay.
Give Brody back one.
Okay. They're still lost two. The lost one. I'm confused. Let's move on.
Math.
Did everyone else get that?
No. I don't think anyone's following anything here, Ian.
What? I'm very clear and straightforward.
It's true.
The next question was, finish the line from Blank Atlas's song, Connections. Oh yeah, baby. Show me those enormous...
shoes.
Eyes?
Nope.
No. Is it just going to be tits?
Spike. Spike.
Breasticles.
Patrick.
I guess titties.
Tom.
Yourself.
The answer was in the song name Connections. Oh yeah, baby, show me those enormous connections. You.
Kind of feel like Ab is the closest.
1:30. Yeah, but close doesn't cut it. In the song Euphoria by Kendrick Lamar, what does Kendrick have in his home like Joe?
Beach balls.
Nope.
Oh.
A wheelchair. Did someone say just weed?
A wheelchair. That's it.
A wheelchair.
Like Joe from Family Guy.
Okay, cool. Respectful. The answer is a Benjamin and a Jackson. In the same way that Joe Biden has a portrait of... what was his name? Fucking Thingy Benjamin and then Thingy Franklin, the president.
Okay.
Yes.
Next question. Who sings Ian Skinner's song by Shorty Horror, Hot Dog Boss?
Shorty Horror?
No. No. Trick question.
I have Hot Stradling. Dog and put Mickey Mouse Clubhouse.
Yeah. Elliot Stradling, none of you's got that. Read up. It's literally... yeah, Fuck yous. That one was just for me. Billy, I'd actually love to hear what your answer to this is. If we're you know, borrowing from the same blockbuster video, what does the Wrestler Review podcast claim Mean Gene Oakland's favorite pastime to be?
Golf.
Strip clubs.
Close.
Professional rock, paper, scissors tournaments. No.
Patrick?
Banging rats.
Close. Tom?
Cooking hoes.
Billy?
Well, I know the answer, but I'm going to just throw out wearing a pair of Tims.
Yeah, close. Murder. Wrestling Review Podcast. It's really good.
Is it reading series 3 of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure? Because it's the best one.
I mean, we already did the answer. I don't know if you. I don't know if you were paying attention. I don't know if you could hear because your hair is a bit too loud. Who is the most recent winner of the Young Lions Cup?
This is a total punt, but Ren Narita?
No.
Okay. I Tom Atlas's cat.
Not Ian Skinner, oh. Ken.
Andrew?
I don't watch New Japan. I have no fucking clue.
So who was the most...
See when I said the Chikara thing, I was even in my head, I was like, I can't even think of the last Young Lions Cup in Chikara. I don't know.
It was in 2019, and it was Carl Fredericks, also known as Eddie Thorpe. So a trick question, because it wasn't recent. It was fucking 2019.
You're a shit.
At least I had a
guess. No, you're just shit at answering questions.
Yeah.
What pro wrestling move, speaking of questions, you liked this one. What pro wrestling move did the Power Rangers use to defeat Goldar in the 2017 Power Rangers movie?
Was it a black hole slam?
No.
I didn't watch it because I'm not a VL, so sorry.
The Doomsday Device.
No, that would have been sick, though.
My guess was the Spirit Squad finisher. All the Power Rangers just picked him up and shot him in the air.
The Spirit Bomb.
Aye.
Patrick, how are you married? How?
Spirit Squad slammed it here, by the way.
I mean, Andrew's close. Spike, do you have any answer?
It was me that put Doomsday Device.
Ah, but Tom.
I put the 3D just because it was the first thing that came to my head.
It was a bridging German suplex.
Makes sense.
It's pretty fucking sick. It just out of nowhere as well. It's the only wrestling move they do.
Leon
and
Kennedy
they do
style,
a bridging
like
variation
it.
As well. Even like it's not going to get, they're in a Megazord. It's not going to get a pin. Like,
Go spot.
What popular, it's not a spot, it was just a move. Calm down. What popular character did Mark Bonanno portray in the most recent episode of The Most Upsetting Guessing Game?
Lucha DS.
Yeah.
Zach Gowen's leg.
Popular character.
Margaret Thatcher.
I just wanted to define that.
I've never seen the fucking show, so I have no idea.
Yeah, it's free on YouTube. I don't think you've got any excuses there. It is there. Awesome. It is free. You don't need a subscription for it. But it was Meltman.
What?
Meltman.
Popular character.
Popular character, Meltman. Yeah.
Popular amongst who?
Ian Skinner.
Ian Skinner.
Let's fucking go. What film? Wait, no, that was the bonus question. We'll wait to the bonus question. Who are the current Sovereign Pro Wrestling champions? 4 to be listed.
Chewy, Louie, Chewy, and Gooey.
See, it was if there
was Cody Adler and Andrew Drummond.
Just a quick one there. If we had 3 questions where they're like 4, that would have been great. But now we're not going to get to pay that off, unfortunately. But I think, Spike, I heard your answer, and I think you're incorrect. Tom?
Skinner, Miller. Fuck. Who beat you for the cup? Fuck.
I actually didn't get beaten for the cup. I was eliminated before. So,
shit. So you got beat?
No. Wait, are you saying me and Simon are the tag champs? Yeah.
No, you're Commonwealth champ. I think Miller has the cup. Tag champs. I'm gonna take a punt and say Subculture Joseph Connors heavyweight champion. That's a complete fucking guess.
Ah, Tom, you're trying so hard and it's depressing me.
Hey, at least he's trying, Brody. Okay.
Exactly. I'm putting an effort, or you're not. So sit down and shut up. Yeah?
No, Tom. Okay. Don't fucking like. I was backing you up. Don't fucking chime in.
Okay. Fucking. All right then. Yeah. Jesus.
Hey, where are you going? Where do you need to go? Where do you need to go? Open up the door. Get in the fridge.
He's actually doing it as well. He actually, I believe he will go in the fridge.
Anyone else have any punts?
I was predicting you've gone on like a Kurt Angle 07 run in TNA and you've just got all the belts.
Not yet. But, you know, I'll email you in a year's time.
Nice.
I just wanted to say you're so handsome and I can't wait to speak to you at 3 a.m.
Okay. So the answers there are L.A. Taylor, women's champion, Bullet Benno, or Bullet, the one-man armory, world heavyweight champion, me, Commonwealth champion, and the 8-7 tag champions. Here we go. And lastly, the bonus question for 10 points, Billy, 10 points, note this down. Actually, 5. Change, right. Scribble it out, 5. Are you writing in pen or pencil?
I've got a pen.
What if I make any changes, okay?
I'll just scribble it out, it's fine.
All right, 2 points. What is the film that Billy has still not seen? That 5 points, 5 points, actually. We'll keep it there. We'll keep it right here. Cut to an ad right now.
Do you want your...
Ken, bring it back. What film has Billy still not seen, which, and the fact that he's still not seen it upsets me?
Godzilla.
I think that, I imagine that is correct, but also not the answer.
The Batman?
Ho, ho, ho.
The Batman.
All right, yes, there we go. I was thinking in my head that was the right year. How have you not seen that? I mean, it is shite, like.
What the fuck do you mean?
It is shite. It's a waste of time.
Well, you know what I think's a fucking waste of time?
Getting
stabbed with glass.
It's fine.
Getting stabbed with glass for 30 quid. Never doing that again.
Not even, you get a hot dog.
Okay, no, I still
need to speak
to police about it.
I've got 5, but that's fine. I'm happy with that.
Yeah, that hooker I killed still needs to. Anyway. One final bonus question that doesn't really have an answer. Would you rather have unlimited bacon but no games, or games, unlimited games but no games?
Unlimited bacon?
Yeah.
I don't play fuck all.
Yeah.
I don't like bacon.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, there's no game for that answer, but...
Are you wishing to stick around for the actual point tally, or...?
God, no. Don't fucking ever invite me back on for a quiz.
Fair. Well,
Listen, I'm wearing sunglasses because I did a double pat trick today, okay? I'm going to assume you just let off a flashbang in one eye.
No, you assume wrong.
With that awkwardness, thank you very much for Ian Skinner for providing the second round of our quiz for the Day of Birth Bonanza. It has certainly been around, and we'll do the tally up of scores shortly. But the real thing has been on the podcast one more time. Thank you very much, Ian. Everyone, give him a round of applause.
No.
No? Okay. Are you staying really still? Have you glitched?
My name's Deez. Deez.
Not fucking getting me with that.
Is he all right? Like,
yeah, he's
just in general.
He's like my most hated and most loved person on this planet. and I can't.
That's the first thing I've ever spoken to him in my life.
Can I also point out, right, I have some very potent rum here, and he forced me to finish that with his patter.
What are you on? What are you on?
It's a bottle, and it's got an X on it.
Oh.
That's all nice. I know.
Right, that's all you need.
I see fluids, and nice. Bye-bye.
Cool.
So, were you keeping track of your points? I'm too afraid to ask, I think.
I could barely keep track of my life there.
Andrew, how many points did you get?
Just based on the Batman question, I got 6 altogether. Only got Stone Cold's cat right, and all the rest were wrong. So I don't know fucking any other answers for that. But
Brody, how many did you get?
Right, so I'm going to make you a deal here, right? If I tell you how many points I got, then you can like drag out the other 3 schmucks while I get rum. Is that a deal? I'll tell you how many points I got.
Yeah, that's fine.
I'm going to go for a piss as well.
I got 1.
You got 1. Grand.
He's not going to like this, Billy.
Patrick?
Yeah, I just got 1 poncho as well.
So you got 3 points because you got 2 from Ian.
Oh, yeah.
I was keeping track. I mean, I was going to bring up to Brody, if she only got 1 right, she technically got -1. So I think we'll leave that for just for our own sanity. Spike.
I didn't get any of that round.
Oh, that means I think Tom is going to pull ahead. So, Tom, how many?
I got a singular point. I got CBF because I didn't get the cat or anything else.
To be fair, that was the most complicated question. And that's the one you got right.
Of course, it's the most complicated question, the most British wrestling question that I get right.
I swear he's Austin's got a new cat called like Macho Man, but I assumed he was going to be asking about Poncho.
Yeah, Macho.
That's like the well-known cat is Poncho.
That's
the one that sort of crawls on him, but he's like walking around.
You mentioned Twitter, and it was like I tried to log back into my old wrestling Twitter, and I just couldn't remember it, so I just stay off it.
He has messaged nicely, just said, just to double check that is everyone okay? Everyone's
no, but thanks for coming in anyway.
nice to meet him.
Tom, if you want, you could go for another long stand.
Yeah, get some tartan pain. Ask for a reach around.
Whoa, Patrick. Not from you. Okay.
So we're just waiting for Brody to come back. Andrew, you were very quick. Did you wash your hands?
Oh yeah, of course I did.
Good lads.
All right. I'm drinking Aldi's anti-establishment beers. The cans aren't going to be clean anyway, are they?
No. Yeah. I did one shift as a supposed to be like as a job, like trial, and that was enough for me. To be honest, I worked for
Lidl for 9 months, and it was very fucking intense.
Were you a manager?
No, but my manager was my manager was a dick, and that's the reason I left. Happy days now.
It seems like the sort of job where you'd be kind of left to do everything. Like shite type thing.
You have to do absolutely everything, and you have to do it at like times 10 speed, and if you don't do it at that, then you just get fucking bollocked all the time.
Right.
That's your wife? Yeah.
Sounds great.
No, actually, no.
Hi, I'm back.
Your wife that you don't high five on your own entrance.
He did.
I mean, Tom, I've got a wife, so get back in your fridge.
Well, I'm 22 and I've got time to figure it out. Shut up, right?
But Tom, you're also banned from women.
We're not getting into this. Not on the fucking podcast. We're not getting into this.
Weirdly enough.
This is for the group chat. Shut the fuck up.
What a segue, because the third round, the palate cleanser, is the one my wife wrote.
Hey!
So,
I thought you were going to say it was about Tom's love life. I got really excited there.
Up the wife's round.
You watch yourself, Patrick. Right, Mrs. SWN's Movie Mania is the one I took the only one I had the effort of writing the round for. So you've got 10 questions. There are some bonus points on offer. I will tell you what they entail as we go along. It's a movie quiz, a movie round. There is 2 questions on a film, so 5 films, 2 questions on each. Keep us nice and light. So, just to double check, everyone okay so far? 2 rounds in?
I've recovered from being Skinner somewhat, but I'm left with some relative PTSD from that, but we'll continue.
Yeah, I'm going to need some aloe vera for those burns, bro.
Aloe vera, fucking nuts, being playing it fucking gently, man. Fuck.
That was a lot of fucks there, Tom.
What's your language? That was boy.
Absolutely terrible.
Anyway, two for 2 points. What is Harry Potter's date of birth? So you'll get a point for the date, a point for the year.
Wish I knew your wife was as much of a nerd as you.
Right.
Harry Potter based in the time that it comes out?
Yeah. Based in the books. Yeah.
Not Daniel Radcliffe.
Well, how the fuck is that a movie question, Billy?
Because it was made into a movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's they don't say the date of his birthday in the movie.
Exactly.
Well, did you say the date? Did you see the date in the movie? I'm sure. They don't say the year because.
Right, where's our fact checker? Because I reckon...
What are the odds we'll get through all five movies and I've not seen a single one?
I'm joining you.
Oh, what's Spike's year?
So, what is Harry Potter's date of birth? Okay, I shouldn't have called it Movie Mania. We'll call it Mrs. SWN's Nerd Round. So everyone got an answer? Or?
Yeah.
When do the kids go back to school? Because it's about then, isn't it?
I don't know. My kid's like not two. I don't need to worry about school. Question two. So, of course, it's about Harry Potter as well. What is the name of Hagrid's pet dragon? You get a bonus point for the type of dragon.
Are these all Harry Potter questions?
No, there's two questions per, per subject.
Didn't he have two?
No.
Sorry, I don't know where that accent came from there. Didn't he have two?
No, are you thinking of the massive spider?
I thought you had a thing that got killed.
William, I know the difference between a dragon and a spider, right?
Are you thinking of the hippogriff?
That's what I'm thinking of. That's not a dragon.
The hippopotamus?
No, hippogriff.
You're just making up words now.
All words
you're just
made
as bad as J.K. Rowling.
No words are made up.
What is the name of Hagrid's pet dragon? Bonus point for time.
I don't know what.
Touché. That was quite good. I'll give you little shit.
Oh dear. Right. Question three. So that's a Harry Potter section done. Question three. In the movie Forrest Gump, which ward does Forrest fight in? There is a bonus point for how you give the answer.
What forest does Forrest fight in?
In the movie Forrest Gump, which ward does Forrest fight in?
What was the second part of the question?
You get a bonus point for how you say it.
How he's there? Or...
How he says the answer.
Okay.
Did you say what was his role when he was...
No, just which war.
Oh, just which war? All right, sorry. I thought you meant like what job was in the war. That's fine.
Question four. Also in the movie Forrest Gump, which US presidents does he meet? So there's 3 points available for this.
What was that, sorry?
Also in the movie Forrest Gump, which US presidents does he meet? So 3 points.
Why would there be 3 points for it?
Because there's, I think you could probably put two and two together. Or three and three.
Fucking dragon.
Dragon D's nuts. There you go. Oh, God, Ian Skinner.
Wow.
Testing my president.
Is that how old you are, Billy? Christ.
Right, he's been hanging around Ian too much. I think we need to detox him a little bit because that was fucking bad.
I think he's been on like six times in a quiz. He's probably been on about 8 episodes at this point. So that's quite high.
Billy, I mean this as a friend. Is everything okay?
You're not Billy's friend. Why would you say that? It's great.
I'm okay. Question five. Which boot of Woody's is Andy written on in Toy Story?
Which boot? Film I've seen.
Wait. Now, of course, this will be in the first two films and most of the third, because in the fourth, it was Bonnie that was written on his foot.
Can we not talk about the fourth film? It's fucking awful.
Oh, there's a fifth film coming.
I know, you watch your damn mouth.
It's fucking shite, Brody, and you know it.
Who are you? Shut it. Sorry, I'm just I'm really, really defensive over Toy Story, bro.
Oh, no, Toy Story 1 to 3, like, honestly, goat tier. But 4, it's like cash grab city, even though technically the second and third ones were as well. But 4 is just awful.
I like 9. 7 was my favourite. But...
Are you just doing that for continuity purposes and we'll watch this in about 5 years?
Future-proofing it.
Yeah.
So that's which Monster boot of Woody's is Andy written on in Toy Story?
It's bloody dragon.
I mean, we technically got a 50-50 shot at that question, right?
You do, you would think.
Well, on top.
Question 6, of course, about Toy Story, and I think with Brody's defence, she might have a good shot at this one. Which of these is not a character in any of the Toy Story movies? So it's Gabby Gabby, Mr. Prickle Pants, Action Man, or Stinky Pete?
What?
Which of these is not a character in any of the Toy Story movies? Gabby Gabby, Mr. Prickle Pants, Action Man, or Stinky Pete?
Oh. Oh.
I think I've got that, actually.
Yeah. Question 7. In which year does the first scene of Guardians of the Galaxy take place?
Ugh. Another film I've seen.
We know you've seen it.
That wasn't me.
Batista's in it, so
that's Party Guy Brandon. He's completely different.
Is that why you've seen it? Because Batista's in it. That's the one Batista one, right?
It is, but it's not the reason why. I've seen I've seen the Marvel stuff.
Bloody dragon.
In which year does the first scene of Guardians of the Galaxy take place?
Brody, it really seems like you're dragging that question out.
Oh!
Why?
I was actually quite clever.
Don't
Why? Oh, that was good. No, you have to give him that. Come on. Like, you have to give credit where credit's due. That was quite good.
He had a 3-point head start in the sitting second last. So, like, go give him some kudos. Question 8. Who provides the voice for Rocket Raccoon?
What?
Oh, fuck.
Rocket Raccoon.
Oh, that guy.
Oh, God.
I mean, fuck my hope so.
So, who provides the voice for Rocket Raccoon?
Oh, he's pretty.
No, I don't do the voice. It's someone else.
Hey.
You're not pretty. You're handsome.
Ah. Compliments will get you nowhere in this quiz. Question 9. In The Nightmare Before Christmas, what are the names of Oogie Boogie's henchmen? 3 points on offer.
Bitch, please! This is my... Oh, that's sad. That is my life.
I had to turn that film off halfway through because it was that bad. It was fucking awful.
Do you like any movies, Patrick?
No. I know I've heard the wrath of Brody Adler, but you know, it's fucking awful.
See, seriously, for a second, right? Going to break character. That really, really hurt, man. That was...
Like, I was my missus showed me it. I wanted to like it because she likes it. And I was just like, nah, I can't hack this.
Look, Patrick,
do you like my wee guy?
Yeah. I like Pikachu. You know, can get on board with
Pikachu. That. Sorry, I've been trying not to swear.
Oh, you can swear. We're not monetized, so it doesn't really
matter. I've got Squirtle here. Squirtle's up there. Yeah.
Patrick, Patrick, I mean this with full disrespect. You're an Oasis fan. You can't say much.
Oh, no.
Ah, yeah, you wear bucket hats, don't you? I've just been a Fez on those dicks, so you're fine.
Bucket hats are cool.
Right,
Fezes are cool.
Shut up, you're too late to redeem yourself.
Would you rather I wore a fez?
I forgot what question 8 was now, Chris.
Question 8 was who provides the voice of Rocket Raccoon?
Oh, so it was, yeah.
Question 9. In The Nightmare Before Christmas, what are the names of Oogie Boogie's henchmen? 3 points on offer, so you get a point for each. And question 10. What does Jack Skellington call Santa?
Call what?
What does Jack Skellington call Santa?
Oh, okay.
Right, do you want any repeated?
Yeah, can you repeat the second one about 5 times until it comes to my head, please?
I'll do it once. What is the name of Hagrid's pet dragon? Bonus point for type of dragon.
I can see the stupid wee thing. Oh, God.
That type like of dragon. Problem. Is there various different types of dragons in Harry Potter?
There's sure. Several, yeah.
Unfortunately.
Oh, fucking hell. That's fine. I've only seen them once and I hated them all, so it's fine.
So this seems what we've learned in this podcast so far, third round, is nobody likes movies particularly.
Movies that are these films.
Yeah, there's a theme here. There is a theme here, Billy.
So to the answers.
Horror films, it'd be all right. But
I don't watch any of them, so that's
yeah, horror films would have been great, but never mind.
Say number eight again.
Number eight. Who provides the voice for Rocket Raccoon? The answers. Question one was, what is Harry Potter's date of birth? Anyone want to take a crack at it?
I wrote September 11th, and I have a feeling that's wrong.
I guessed he was born in 1984, because I'm sure that the books are like sort of mid-90s they start.
His birthday, not his birth year. Stop looking so much into it.
Birth year was the bonus.
Yeah, I guessed Halloween 1984. Like,
I take it so seriously.
The answer.
14th. Is that right?
The answer. Who said like during the summer holidays? Someone said that.
Nobody was asking that.
Yeah, 31st of July 1980.
Right. So I'm going to argue continuity here. Right. His birthday was the day that Hagrid came to take him to Hogwarts. Right. Why is a kid starting in July?
Yeah, it was.
Why is that happening?
Wizard school, isn't it?
Aye, wizard.
Yeah.
That's like one of those answers where you ask something and it's because wrestling.
But maybe just Hogwarts isn't affiliated with the SQA, so they don't have to do the same sort of school year.
Patrick, you're not getting bonus points for sucking up.
No, I'm just pointing out, you
know. The logic is there.
Yeah.
Exactly. I mean, it's a boarding school as well, so you know.
Yeah, exactly. Do the one.
Travel all the way down to London to come back up to Scotland.
I know. No.
Nurse. What is the name of Hagrid's pet dragon? Question two.
Was it Norbert? Dragon. Tell me it was Norbert.
It was Norbert.
Yes, man.
Anyone want Toothless. I know there's a dragon called Toothless somewhere.
That's How to Train Your Dragon.
Yes,
mate. Anyone take a crack at the type?
That's the best thing that's happened to me in the past week.
Type of dragon.
Wow. No. No idea.
Are these going to be innocuous, like stupid names of dragons?
He was a Norwegian.
He was a Norwegian ridgeback.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Okay. No, you're not getting half a point for it.
Is that good?
Hold on, I thought we were doing half fucking points.
Clear your ears. You've got big lugs. I said no half point there.
Good.
I just wrote down the dragon's name as Jim.
Good.
That would be better, wouldn't it? If they just gave them normal names, that would be so much better.
Look, I just wrote down cunt because I really didn't know.
Language. Three. In the movie.
We're not monetized, Billy. Come on.
Not with that attitude. Not with that attitude, Tom. Come on.
I'll never get invited to the press passes at WWE at this rate. Not bitter about it. Question three. In the movie Forrest Gump, which war does Forrest fight in? You get a bonus point for how you say it.
Did he go to Vietnam?
He was in Vietnam.
Vietnam.
You don't know, man. You weren't there.
Anyone want to take a punt for the bonus?
I put the Great War.
Did I get the bonus, sir?
The Great War.
No, the bonus is for saying Viet fucking Nam.
Oh,
right.
I should
have
known that.
That sucks. I put a lot into that impression, and I didn't even get in for it. Somebody
at work today called me Forrest Gump, so I really probably should have watched it before this.
Who gave you a job?
Look, you can go.
Question four. Also in the movie Forrest Gump, which that really hurt, Tom. That really hurt. also the movie Forrest Gump, which US president does he meet?
Was it JFK?
Ronald Reagan?
Reagan.
Or Richard Nixon?
That was my guesses.
JFK, Richard Nixon, and Lyndon B. Johnson.
Ah!
Johnson? That's made up.
It sounds like someone's breaking in.
Someone's seen Forrest Gump in this chat.
Not for about 25 years, no.
No, I've never seen it, but I thought if he was in Vietnam, then there would have been some of those presidents around about at that point.
I don't watch films. I'm still trying to learn how to wrestle, so, yeah.
Put that. Which boot? Question 5. Which boot of Woody's is Andy written on in Toy Story?
The right one.
Correct.
Because the left is wrong and the right is right.
That was a political statement, though.
That's how I remember it.
Right, we're getting cancelled. Thanks for coming along, guys.
Is it right? Is that the answer?
Yep, right boot.
All right, fuck that.
Tory Brody at the bottom there with right.
She can join Thatcher's cabinet.
Right is right, left is wrong.
You said left is wrong, right is right.
Yeah. That's one way to get the show cancelled. Cheers, Brody.
That's the way up to an election, you need to be bloody careful, really.
Oh yeah, the election is 2 days time from this coming out, amazing. So hopefully that hasn't swayed anyone in particular to vote.
I didn't know you were a massive fan of Thatcher, right, bro?
Imagine that on the front of the Sun with the headlines like it was the SWN podcast.
I'll vote for anyone what swung
it. Brody Adler, right is right.
There's a massive surge in conservative voting in Scotland because of Brody Adler.
Or do you know what? It might work out even better and nobody will vote for the Tories.
That's true. Yeah, that's true.
Question 6. Which of these is not a character in any of the Toy Story movies? So Gabby Gabby, Mr. Prickle Pants, Action Man, Stinky Beat.
Mr. Prickle Pants.
Yeah, Mr. Prickle Pants.
But he was the hedgehog.
I put Gabby Gabby.
God. Gabby Gabby not in the third one?
Gabby Gabby's in the third one. Mr. Prickle Pants was in the third one. Stinky Beat was in the second one.
Action Man!
Oh.
Shit!
I am absolutely slaying this shit.
In which year does the first scene of Guardians of the Galaxy take place?
1984.
That's what I wrote, yeah.
1980.
Oh.
Did I get a book? No, I'm just playing.
No, don't. No. 8.
Best. Next one's killing me.
Brody, who provides the voice of Rocket Raccoon?
His name's Bradley.
Bradley Cooper.
Bradley Cooper.
That's what I said.
We're going for honesty for the points, so if you can live with yourself with that, then...
Nah, I got Bradley, and I kept on saying Bradley Walsh, and I was like, it's really not Bradley Walsh. So.
Only if, by the way.
How cool would that be, though?
Because they're going, we're the freaking guardians of the Fanny Schmeller here. right, question 9. In the Nightmare Before Christmas, what are the names of Oogie Boogie's henchmen?
Lock, Shock, and Barrel.
Correct. Lock, Shock, and Barrel.
Is that 3 points or one?
3 points.
Awesome.
1 point.
Each. Eat it, Patrick.
Billy.
I don't even know if I got to that point before I switched off, so to be fair.
Rude. I've got a question. If I lose, can you send me a wooden spoon? And I'm being completely fucking serious.
If you finish last, yeah.
Sounds good.
I have a question as well.
Right.
If a dog was to wear trousers, would it wear it on its back legs only, or all four?
All four, come on.
You know what, I might reinstate that minus 1 point.
Back legs only.
Yeah, back legs.
Get an answer about my giraffe.
No, you might be right with the back legs, actually, yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Back legs I've only. Literally got a giraffe outside waiting to go to a party, and he doesn't know how to wear his bow tie, so Ian Skinner, that's on you, bud.
Question 10. What does Jack Skellington call Santa?
Sandy Claus.
Correct, Sandy Claus.
Don't mess with me when it comes to Nightmare.
I went down Andy's route and just put Barry because I wanted him to have a proper, just normal name.
I said Mr. Presence, but then again, I've seen that for once. Many years ago.
Also, the name of my dog.
Mr. Presence?
What, Barry?
Sandy Claus.
All right, I was like, why is it called that?
Why, you should call your next pet Barry.
Huh?
No. Or Steve, just something really normal.
I'm not shouting that across the field. I look weird enough shouting Sandy across the field.
Did you call him Doug?
Doug the Doug.
Oh,
Doug,
for Doug. Fucks.
Anyway, with that, Andrew, what was your points?
3. Shite.
So, Brody.
Nine.
Very right-leaning for that. Patrick.
I got my two presidents, so that's 2 points, yeah.
Spike.
I got three.
Tomothy.
The fuck?
Just answer it.
One. But I'm not fucking Tomothy.
If you ever want to really annoy him, call him Thomas.
When you're angry with him.
Spike is tyranny. Shut the fuck up. No!
So after three rounds, the points are as follows. Andrew is in the lead with 14 points. Brody is in second with 13. Patrick and Spike are next with 12 apiece. And Tom, despite having a 3-point lead, is on last with 9.
Look, I'm a Liverpool fan. I'm thinking back to Istanbul. I'm going to be fine, right?
Okay.
Wow, that has absolutely everything to do with everything.
Yes. See, she gets it.
Okay.
She, her.
Next round, round four. We're almost there, people. Round four is called Grant McIver is still doing the wrestling quiz. As you can tell, it is curated by Grant McIver.
Oh, this is going to be about the bloody Simpsons, isn't it?
It's all wrestling.
Can we wait till my man gets home till we do the Simpsons questions? Because I cannot.
I mean, wait, I've got no Simpsons questions on here, so.
I've got a Bret Hart question.
I don't think so. Maybe.
Is there wrestling questions?
These are all wrestling questions.
I'm just as screwed then.
And there's
may as well just take the helmet off now.
What?
My poor helmet of success. Chuck, Tom, just because you don't have a helmet.
Question one. So these are all by Grant McIver, so I've trusted that he has checked all of it. Before his retirement at WrestleMania 25, sorry, before his retirement after WrestleMania 25, what was the only WrestleMania that Triple H missed since his debut at WrestleMania 12?
Oh.
As a wrestler or in general?
As a wrestler.
That's a dumb question, I'm sorry.
In the 1 point.
So before his retirement after WrestleMania 25, what was the only WrestleMania that Triple H missed since his debut at WrestleMania 12?
Never retired at WrestleMania 25.
Yeah, I was about to.
He wrestled
35. Okay.
Oh, 35. Oh, God.
Yeah.
35. Okay.
I may have said 25.
Can I just ask what WrestleMania was this year?
40.
Thank you.
Because it was XL.
35 cutting backwards.
I don't like that they don't number them anymore. It makes them more difficult to remember.
Well, they started numbering them again from this year onwards. Yeah.
Thank God. They started numbering them again.
Oh, good.
It's easier to remember them.
Yeah. Yeah, Las Vegas is 41.
Yeah, it's good.
Question two. Under what name have both Edge and Christian and the Hardy Boys won the tag team titles?
Yeah, boy.
Oh, fuck.
This is more like it, Billy.
Yeah,
this is grand. That's under what name have both Edge and Christian and the Hardy Boys won the tag team titles?
Oh, wait, no, it's not that. It's slightly different.
What do you mean under what name?
I don't know how I can make that any clearer, to be honest.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Under what name have both Edge and Christian and the Hardy Boys won the tag team titles? They both won the tag team titles under a certain name.
Okay, thanks. That was really helpful.
I know. I don't.
You know, we'll no, move. It wouldn't be that. It would be
just exposing me as like a really new wrestling fan. So thank you. Thanks very much for that.
Look, you opted into this quiz.
I'll also punch your face, but you know what? Not everything's right.
But that is. Right is right. Question three. Question three, who has the shortest world title reign in WWE? That includes WWF. I know somebody will be picking out.
The shortest.
Ah, shit. Oh, sorry.
You can swear, don't worry. That's fine.
Right. Know,
Tom said cunt.
Multiple times.
You may give multiple answers for this.
He's got people he's trying to impress.
There is one answer for this. Who has the shortest world title reign in WWE?
Yes. Who's the shortest world?
I was going to say, because some people have heard it for only a day, so it has to be less than that.
Yeah.
I think I got that.
So this one might trip you up. Question four. Who Who was the first British man or woman to hold a singles title in WWE?
The first British man or woman.
Would it have to be shoot from Britain?
Yes.
Oh, damn it.
So there goes Roddy Piper. Nice.
Not Roddy Piper.
Because he's Canadian.
I mean, yeah, Roddy Piper.
It's less funny when you point it out, Tom.
Are you going back to like WWWF days or just WWF onwards?
Well, I've just got WWE as the question here, so we'll go with that.
That's fine.
I mean, that doesn't like.
So sorry, can you just repeat that one more time, please?
Question: like, how old?
The question is: who was the first British man or woman to hold a single title in WWE?
Right. Cool.
It's going to be wrong.
Question five. What was the first year the Royal Rumble winner was awarded a WrestleMania title shot?
Oh. Okay.
So that's what was the first year the Royal Rumble winner was awarded a WrestleMania title shot?
Because
we're halfway through the round, I will note that if there is any issues with the questions and the answers, I've trusted Grant McIver. Take any issues up with him. You can moan about it on here, but I will not be able to help.
You can trust Grant McIver. He's fine. He's a good lad. Good source boy.
So, six. Who has won the Royal Rumble twice and lost the WrestleMania title match twice?
Oh. Ooh. Same wrestler. Yeah.
Yep.
He's won the Rumble twice and lost their title match.
Interesting.
That narrows it down quite a bit to like.
It was him.
Look at these guys knowing stuff about wrestling.
It's nerds.
Was it him? No, it wasn't. No, it must have been him.
Do you have any questions on Brewdog?
Brody is really
oddly specific.
That's oddly very right is right as well.
that's a new character we need to happen for the like.
Their reputation's gone a bit south in recent months.
Or it might have gone a bit right, depending on who you ask.
Question seven. Who copied and pasted it and I typed it out and I've typed it out wrong for a second.
Okay, no fucking what's that?
Who was the last person to wrestle two matches bell to bell on a single WrestleMania show?
I think I have this.
It is worded specifically for that. That is your help and clue. So who's the last person to wrestle two matches bell to bell on a single WrestleMania show?
So they wrestled twice?
Bell to bell, yes.
Okay.
So twice
in a row. Oh, yeah. Good.
Two matches bell to bell.
Yeah, all good.
But if you're confused about that, it'll all come clearer when I'm doing the answer.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're talking one after another.
So two matches bell to bell. They don't have to be concurrent against each other. Just bell rang, had a match, bell rang, finished. And they had that twice in one WrestleMania show.
Okay.
Ooh.
I got that.
Yeah, right.
Wait, hang on, how are we defining show?
A single WrestleMania show.
Okay, so...
So it can't be over two nights.
Oh, you fucker.
If I write down two answers, can I choose one of them when you give us the answer?
No, that's fine.
The answer is fuck no.
No, that's fine.
Was I asking you, Thomas?
I didn't even hear what you asked. What did you ask?
If I write down my two options of answers and I get one of them right, can I just select that one and get the point anyway because my hair's nice?
No.
Sorry, you go for hair. Here, this is... No, I'm just jealous of your hair. So no.
I'm sorry. Read your audience, Alex. Christ.
Was part of that question if they won the matches or just they wrestled?
No,
that was the Rumble one.
Okay,
which I thought I had right, but I've realised now I don't. I'm panicking.
Question eight: who has the quickest cash in of the Money in the Bank briefcase?
The quickest.
So we're counting the women's one as well.
Yeah.
Shit.
Oh, that was a lovely hint. Thank you.
Oh, no, the women's one fucks it. That's a guess. This is a guess. Fuck it.
So sorry, Billy, just because I'm thinking in between questions. Number six was, somebody's run that won the Rumble twice but lost both matches at Mania.
Yeah.
Right, cool.
So that's question eight. who has the quickest cash in of the Money in the Bank briefcase. So not like they've cashed in, they've had the quickest match. Won the briefcase, then cashed in.
Yeah.
The shortest amount of time in hours and minutes to win the briefcase and then cash it in.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah. Question 9. Who has Hulk Hogan lost the WWE title to the most?
Right. Question on this. Hulk Hogan lies about everything.
I mean, to be fair,
this is going to be true.
To be fair, there's pay-per-view evidence of this. So, unless he's very good at Photoshop, which if he was, he would have been able to make his sex tape more entertaining. I'm sure this is right. So,
I wouldn't know, Billy. I'm an innocent young lady. I wouldn't watch that kind of film. I wrote Billy for question 9. So,
I have a fact, even though I have one because I'm a BL apparently. I have not been Hulk Hogan for the WWE title.
If I called you a BL, because whenever I say it like that, I mean exclusively Tom.
Virgin lips.
What does that phrase mean?
Virgin lips.
All right. Okay.
I just replied to Tom, like, Billy, I love you, you're great. Besides, you have a kid, so I would kind of hope, like...
Oh, no, I was about to say something that I definitely won't out, so I'll leave it there. Anyway, question 10. At what WrestleMania did The Rock win his first main event?
Oh, interesting wording. Yes. Yes.
Oh, goodness. Calm down, Patrick Christ. That.
Yes.
Win his first main event.
Oh, fuck. Yes. Yes.
At WrestleMania.
Someone tell me what year it was and I'll do the maths, please.
No.
Okay. Worth a shot. Like, you don't actually get it.
At WrestleMania, at what WrestleMania did The Rock win his first main event?
Can you just repeat number 9 again, please, Billy?
Number 9.
Can I say what year?
Who has Hulk Hogan lost the WWE title to the most?
Fucking him, right?
Definitely not him.
What did you say was 8 again, Billy?
8 was who has the quickest cash in of the Money in the Bank briefcase?
Okay.
Grant McIver has provided 2 bonus questions.
That was a good round, by the way. I'll say, or even before the bonus questions, that was a good round.
So the 2 bonus questions.
Bonus are... points, Patrick.
Oh, there's a big bonus point round here.
Right, I'm going to have to ask for question 8, 9, and 10 again because I'm really, yeah.
8 bad was, things. Who has the quickest cash in of the Money in the Bank briefcase? 9 was, who has Hulk Hogan lost the WWE title to the most? And 10, at what WrestleMania did The Rock win his first main event?
But Hogan doesn't lose.
Well, he lost the American multiple hero? Times.
Really?
First sure bonus. First bonus for 9 points.
Oh.
There are 9 married couples who have won the men's WWE championship and any of women's world title. So old and new WWE, women's Raw, SmackDown Divas.
Cool. Don't make me write all this down.
Name them. They do not need to have been married at the time, nor currently married, just have been married at one point. So there is 9 potential answers here.
Right, cool.
So you get 9 points. For everyone you get a point. So I'll read that for the listeners again. There are 9 married couples who have won the men's WWE championship and any women's world title. Name them. And the final bonus, which wrestler has won...
You need to give us a bit more time for this
one. Yeah, I know, but I'm thinking like, genuinely,
calm down.
Can you give us like a good fucking 5 minutes or something for this? Because I reckon I could get a lot of these.
I'll reread that again then. There are 9 married couples who have won the men's WWE championship and any women's world title. Name them.
I will
give you a moment then, just to get that.
I really don't have that many pop figures now.
So while you're all thinking of that, before we get the final bonus question, you can go to manscaped.com and use the code SWN20 for all your grooming needs. For 20% off.
They never got married.
And you could use the code SWN10 at renderbomb.com for some cool t-shirts and keyrings and stickers and stuff. They've got a new t-shirt out, which will probably might still be available for Pride Month, saying, I can't remember, be gay, do clotheslines. But our logo's on the back.
Yeah.
Manscape bitches.
Checking the post, please.
One, two.
Oh, that's one I didn't.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
Right, are we in a position where I can move on to the last question?
No, absolutely not, mate. No.
Oh, no, I've got six as well. I'm trying to think of some more.
Mate, I'm still on question eight. Like, I'm not.
I mean, if I read this question, by the time I've went through the answers, you may be able to get the last, like, three.
Oh! Can't think about two things at once, I'll just crumble.
Tom, you can't think of one thing at once. So, anyway, right, bonus. Second bonus question. Which wrestler has won, but not necessarily held, who won the most different designs or names of the WWE title? This is the clue. This person has won seven different named or styled WWE championships.
Yeah.
I'm not asking answers. I'm just saying he's got permission to be in the living room, that's all. I'm not asking things. So... cool. That sounded really suspicious, but I meant it.
Sorry, Billy, was that world titles? Yeah, WWE titles.
Yep.
We're counting the Winged Eagle and things like that in this WWE world titles.
I mean, that's a different style.
Are we counting the world heavyweight title as in the Ruthless Aggression one as part of the WWE title because it got unified with that?
Right, I've got the answer from it. So, right, okay. No, not really. Okay. It's a WWE championship.
Okay, no, that's fine. That's fine. That's clear. That's fine.
Okay, is this like question 11, growing arms and legs? Because
I just wanted to clarify. Just wanted to clarify a couple of things, Brody. That's fine. That's fine.
No, I'm just asking. Has it got arms and legs?
Yeah. Wait, hold on. That's it.
So this wrestler has won seven different named or styled WWE championships.
One, two, three.
Mm-hmm. Wait, is this another question?
That's the last one. That's the number 12. There's 12 in total.
Okay.
That's my bad. Sorry.
Patrick, shut up. What was the question?
Wait, right, okay. Which wrestler has won, but not necessarily held, but won the most different designs or names of the WWE title?
Oh, okay, cool. No bother. That's fine. Yeah.
Right, ready to go through the answers and you can hopefully get the bonuses while we're doing that.
Sure, I'll take it for those.
Yeah, that helmet isn't going back on. Like, I'm sorry, baby.
So question one, before his retirement after WrestleMania 35, what was the only WrestleMania that Triple H missed since his debut at WrestleMania 12?
Did you say before WrestleMania 35?
After WrestleMania 35.
It was WrestleMania 23 because he did his quad when he was part of DX.
Correct. WrestleMania 23.
Okay, I wrote 30, which comes
after. I said it was like 19, and then I remembered I wrestled for T.
Ah, the racist one.
Yeah, the racist one. A gold mine that was.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Well, you know, I'm gonna think I can tell the black guy that he can't win the world title, and then I'll beat him.
And then he wins. And then he wins the one pedigree. Well, great.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to he's in the room. Break.
I'm going to lie on the canvas for 25 seconds and then go over and cover him.
I like Spike's here. Hi, Spike.
Question two. Under what name have both Edge and Christian and the Hardy Boys won the tag team titles?
The Bridge.
Wrong.
Los Matadores.
Hardy Boys.
It's Los Conquistadores.
You bastard.
Tom, Los Matadores was Epico and Primo when they had
the
win.
Shut the fuck up! I was so confident with the Brood.
The Hardys never won the tag belts as the Brood then, or did Edge and Christian never win them as the Brood?
I don't think Edge Christian ever won them as the Brood.
Oh, God.
I knew it was...
The Hardys did, though, because the Hardys won their first one, teaming with Michael Hayes against the against Darklights. Yeah.
Oh, that's bad.
Terry was with the Hardys? It was like the new Brood?
It was like the contract match or something.
Yeah,
Terry's contract. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The Terry Invitational Tournament.
Yes.
Good name.
Yeah. Three. Who is the shortest world title reign in WWE? And WWF.
Andre the Giant. Or like a minute and a half or something.
Andre the Giant. Not... 1 minute, 45 seconds.
Yeah.
I remember Drew McIntyre. How long was he?
Drew was 5 minutes and 46 seconds, I think it was.
It felt a lot faster. Does that count?
Yeah. Well, he kept
giving away his belt to the Million Dollar Man.
It's counted as an official reign. So yeah,
But then they took it off him again and made a tournament. So how's it?
Yeah, official? And then Macho Man won that.
So it went from Andre to vacant to Macho Man.
The Macho Man won that terrible WrestleMania 4 tournament.
He did, yes.
Okay. Question 4. Who was the first British man or woman to win a singles title in WWE?
Was it the Bulldog? I tried trying to overthink.
Apologies.
It. Actually, is it the Bulldog?
No, I've misread the question. It's singles world title.
You said singles title.
I did. You are correct. Which would be British Bulldog. I will give you a point for Bulldog. The answer is Layla L.
But if we get a point for British Bulldog, that's good, right?
You'll get a point for British Bulldogs. That's
I have
mistake.
That pop final, so that's...
that is my mistake. So if you got Layla L or British Bulldog, you get the point.
Love you, Patrick.
Layla's class. A little bit of Layco.
Question 5. What was the first year the Royal Rumble winner was awarded a WrestleMania title shot?
2011.
92.
1993.
1993.
Fuck yes! Well done, Tom. No. Well done, Tom.
With Yokozuna.
1992 was Flair. 1992
was Flair. 1992 was Flair. They gave.
I couldn't remember if that was 92 or 91 because I knew it was the year after that.
No, Flair's 92.
I forget wrestling was a thing before I watched it. Like
how I pulled that out of my arse, I've got no fucking clue.
So I think that means Tom's going to have double figures, which is incredible.
Yokozuna the wins, isn't it?
Yeah. Yep.
Careful,
yeah.
Charlie.
Is that the one where Macho Man tried to pin him?
Yes.
Yeah,
I forgot the rules of a rumble.
That's a botchable spot.
Yeah.
Oh my god, it is.
Question 6. Who has won the Royal Rumble twice and lost the WrestleMania title match twice?
Was it Edge?
I put Batista.
Edge, yes.
Oh my god, he has won it twice. I put Stone Cold for some reason.
I was convinced it was Cena, but then I remembered he twice in a lifetime.
I couldn't think of Orton winning any of his Mania.
Orton.
He beat Wyatt.
He beat Bray Wyatt. Yeah, I tried to forget about that match as well.
Yeah, it's because Edge won it in lockdown and nobody really remembers it.
Question 8. Who is the quickest cash-in of the Money in the Bank briefcase?
Nikki Cross.
What happened to question 7? Apologies. Who was the last person to wrestle two matches bell to bell on a single WrestleMania show?
Bret Hart.
Drew McIntyre.
Daniel Bryan.
Drew McIntyre wrestled.
I can't remember who, but somebody wrestled Pat McAfee and somebody else.
No. Drew McIntyre wrestled Seth Rollins and then he wrestled Damian Priest in the cash in. Two matches back to back, bell to bell.
What?
The answer I have written down here is Daniel Bryan.
Because it's right. Thank you, Patrick. Go to bed.
Thank you very much.
But I'm not going to give you because this is Grant. This is a Grant McIver's round. But I can see where your argument is with Drew McIntyre.
Patrick, don't argue with Grant McIver, right?
It might have been true when Grant wrote the quiz, but you know.
Well, I got these questions yesterday.
WrestleMania 30.
Well, he's wrong. It was Drew McIntyre.
Hey, stop questioning the gazelle. Christ.
I reckon he would sort of accept that he was wrong.
I think he's if he put a WrestleMania show, then that would probably rule in
The question was stuff. Who wrestled in the last wrestler to wrestle in back to back matches bell to belt WrestleMania? That was Drew McIntyre at WrestleMania 40.
On a
single WrestleMania show, it was on the same night because I originally was thinking, was it Seth Rollins from the main event of night one to the
That was the catch out.
But no, it was Seth versus Drew and then Drew versus Damian Priest. That was the answer to your question.
You're wrong.
If it comes down to one point, we'll have an inquiry.
No, they won't. Patrick's wrong. He doesn't want to accept he's wrong.
I'm not saying that it'll work in his favour. I'm just saying
Brody, you just can't accept that I'm right and you're clutching at the straws.
Do you want to accept the backhand next time I see you?
Me and Brody got the points for it.
Tom, go try to get me on your side. That's not going to work. I don't give a shit about you.
Question 8. Who was the quickest cash in of the Money in the Bank briefcase?
Was I right with my answer earlier?
I didn't hear what it was.
Nikki Cross.
Was it Nikki?
Yep.
I thought it was Bailey.
I wrote Damien Sandow. Was that right?
Was it actually Nikki?
No.
It was Sandow Kane.
Won Money in the Bank, didn't he?
It was still Kane.
Yeah, Sandow did win. Yeah, he lost his match against Cena.
I started writing Kane. I was like, no, it's Cross.
Kane with Money in the Bank. Wait, yeah.
It's the same layers.
Oh, like 2010. Yeah, yeah. He beat. 11, he killed Ray. He absolutely killed Ray.
49 minutes later.
I mean, Nikki is almost an anagram of Kane, so can we get that right?
That's true.
More clutch against Ross and Brody, I don't know.
No.
Clutch at your throat, bitch.
Wait, we still got a massive round left.
Oh, mate, this is heating up. I like it.
A massive round.
Question 9. Who has Hulk Hogan lost the WWE title to the most?
Undertaker.
Oh, shit. Yeah, well done. Good shout.
I've only seen one Hulk Hogan match, though, and it's because I pretty much watch it every day just to get me ready for my day, and it's against Shawn Michaels, so...
was it twice he lost it to Taker, I'm guessing?
Yep.
He lost Survivor Series.
This Tuesday.
And it was Tuesday in Texas, yeah. This Tuesday in Texas.
Undertaker not beat him for the title, for the Undisputed title, where he gave him a terrible choke slam.
He did?
Yeah.
Was that Backlash? No, it wasn't. No, it can't be, because Undertaker won it at Backlash, I think, against Triple H.
I will literally start doing a choke slam in my moveset just to call it the terrible choke slam.
I'll remember that when I'm writing reviews. Question 10. What WrestleMania did The Rock win his first main event?
Was it once in a lifetime?
28.
Yeah, boy.
Right, does that mean
1998?
Nope.
No, that means
2012.
Yeah, 2012.
Really? That late? Wow.
Yeah. He lost all his title matches, didn't he? He always Stone Cold always beat him. And 19 wasn't the main event. It was
WrestleMania 2000 was the four-way and Triple H won that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
His first main event win was John Cena.
I feel sad.
Well, it's not going to be any better with the first bonus question. There are 9 married couples who have won the men's WWE championship in any women's world title. I'm just going to list them. And then makes it easier. Cool. Brock Lesnar and Sable.
I forgot that one as well.
Fuck, yeah.
If I get more time, Billy.
I should have left this for the second time. Bonus.
Yeah.
Triple H and Stephanie McMahon.
Yeah.
Steve Austin and Debra.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Former women's champion Debra.
Yeah.
CM Punk and AJ Lee.
How did I not get that one? That's terrible.
I feel like I've not understood the question and I should get all these points anyway because I know these people are couples.
I think I might have more than 9.
Oh, man. All right.
opportunities. You're fine. You're fine.
We're not here, but apparently we can't do that, so it's fine.
Undertaker and Michelle McCool.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, boy.
Seth Rollins and Becky Lynch.
Yeah.
Daniel Bryan and Brie Bella.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
The Miz and Maryse.
Yeah.
Hey. How about that one?
Yeah.
Edge and Beth Phoenix.
Yeah.
I'll take four out of the 9.
Yep.
So who?
And I'll take two. Vicky.
Vicky never won a world title.
Won a women's belt.
She did
win a women's belt. And then Vicky... he was world champion. So technically they were married at some point. So that would count, wouldn't it?
Vicky Guerrero never won a women's title.
Did she not win a women's title? I'm sure she did. She not won a frog splash. Frog splash something.
She won a
that
match.
That was a match at Mania. It wasn't for a belt.
You ever won the belt? Alberto Del Rio and Paige.
They were never married.
Did they ever officially get married?
Yeah, they got married.
That's correct then. That's correct then.
Tina and Nikki Bella as well.
But we can't go against Grant McIver's world apparently.
All the ones listed seem to be currently married.
I'm going to double check the Alberto Del Rio Paige thing.
Married, and they were both champions for the women's division and the men's division. Maybe not necessarily at the same time, but they were.
Can we give him his full name? Alberto Del Rio, notable prick.
Isn't at the discretion of Grant McIver, who isn't here, and you can't actually get discretion because he's not here.
Yeah.
She became engaged to fellow wrestler Alberto Del Rio. They did not get married.
I nearly put Cena and Nikki Bella as well, but they never actually got married. They broke it off.
Any of the bastards, why
they never quite got married. No,
I think she realized it'd be a terrible idea.
I mean, yeah,
look, imagine me not being able to see your husband. It was
so... Right, I mean, last bonus. Which wrestler has won, not necessarily held, but won the most different designs or names of the WWE title?
John Cena.
And the list.
He won the rated R belt as well, didn't he?
The list I've been given is he won the Undisputed title.
He did.
He won the Spinner.
Yeah.
That's not technically, that's his idea. That's not a different belt.
But he still won it afterwards.
But it's different a different
design.
Belt. Different
and, then the and there's like the different names the as well. Picks. So there was like Undisputed and World WWE World Heavyweight and all this.
Passion. The rated
please,
R.
Please don't take this away from me.
The rated R belt.
No, you're right. Yeah, I'm backing you up, bro.
The Miz Upside Down W.
You can't be counting that, surely. That's like a comedy fucking fake championship.
But it's a championship.
We're counting the Spinner belt as two different belts when the logo is upside down.
Three different belts, because you've got the regular Spinner,
the Miz. The Miz is not a different belt. You just put a stopper in it. The Rated R one's a different belt.
Not according to Grant McIver. The
Scratch WWE logo.
Yeah.
Lads, I need this. Like, my wrestling knowledge is terrible. I need this. Please stop asking questions.
That was the one he beat The Rock for, wasn't it?
The unified
WWE World Heavyweight Championship.
The Brock Lesnar belt.
And the network WWE logo belt.
Yeah. The current
one. So 1 point for that anyway. So, right, okay. Yeah. Andrew.
Cool.
What'd you get?
Are we counting every single point for the people we've got on the bonus question? Couples.
9 points total.
If I'm counting that, I've got 11.
Four.
For everything.
Shit.
Brody.
So technically I got 5. But if you factor in thoughts and prayers, good effort, and really cool hair, then I got 15.
It's still 5. Okay, that's fine. Patrick?
Well, without my correct Drew McIntyre answer, I got 12, but with that I would have got 13.
Oh, someone sounds bitter.
I'm very openly bitter about that.
I got 11.
Grant and Tom.
8.
Right.
Ellie, please tell me I'm still in second. I really need this.
Hang on.
Spike's technically not even here, so he doesn't count because...
So Brody's gone from being far right to saying that certain people are subhuman. So,
so with that,
as
we enter the final round, Andrew is sitting with 25 points, Patrick on 24, Mike with 23.
No,
that's tight.
Don't you dare say Tom is ahead of me. Don't.
Brody with 18, Tom with 16.
That's all that matters.
There's only two in it, though. There's only two in it.
That's the real quiz.
The final
Tom
round
comes fourth because of his 3 extra points.
Ah, yeah, that's true. Tom,
if I beat Brody because of my head start, I'll be fucking buzzing.
You should be fucking ashamed of yourself.
This was an agreement that we made. Thank you. You've been here for the previous quizzes, okay?
Hold on. If Tom is to beat me with his 3 extra points, why should be ashamed of himself? Is it because I'm a woman, Patrick?
No, because he wants to get artificial points to boost his chances.
Well, you know what, Patrick? You weren't here for the last couple of quizzes, okay? If you were here, maybe you would have understood that. What I'm facing, okay?
Final round. You may be glad to hear. It's got a statement. It is. Yeah, absolutely. It's called Brent Carter's Bonanza of Doom.
Fuck.
I will say,
Brent came into my stream the other day I was playing the evil with him. He came into my stream specifically to tell me just how shit this round was going to be and how much I was going to hate it specifically. So, Brent, if you're watching this, fuck you and thank you for the warning.
There are 18 points on offer in this round.
And I missed what the round was about.
It's wrestling.
Yeah,
I find this actually really unfair because I think it's quite clear what my weakest subject is, Billy.
You think that a wrestling podcast we were talking about?
I hate to say it, Brody, but that sounds very much like a you problem.
UKIP problem, yeah, all right. Anyway, right, before we enter the final round, we do have a statement from the 3-time champion of the Day of Birth Bonanza. Oh. He has written the following. Lights, camera, faction. Hello to everyone that I would have defeated this year if I hadn't ever so graciously stepped down from competing in the day of Birth Bonanza in order to finally give someone else a chance at glory. You're welcome. This round is comprised of questions regarding various stables from pro wrestling history. Hopefully it will showcase how important it could be in this business to have friends with similar interests that can look out for you and vice versa. Basically, it's a round to remind you that you all not to be an annoying wee dick like Tom Atlas. All the best. Love, Brent Carter, Fair City Hooligan, undefeated, three-time Day of Birth Bonanza champion.
Nice.
Back to the fridge I fucking go, I guess.
Final round.
I mean, Tom, me and you are in a faction, so we should be good at this.
You say the word should there, Spike.
The word should is so fluid. Like, Tom should be able to get a girl. Tom should be able to do this in the ring. Tom should be able to be an adult. Like, it's just such a loose term, isn't it?
We'll get the first question while he's talking.
A backflip without
What was the point in that?
Question one.
That one fucking hurt, dude. Like, there's no need. There was no need. That one actually hurt, man.
Question one. Who was the last wrestler to officially join the WCW/ECW alliance? So that was, who was the last wrestler to officially join the WCW/ECW alliance?
Thank you.
Question two. Which two factions took part in the first ever AEW Blood and Guts match?
Stop asking wrestling questions.
Oh, fuck. What the fuck were they called?
That's which two factions took part in the first ever AEW Blood and Guts match.
So can I just reiterate what two wrestlers took part in the first Blood and Guts match?
So this round's about factions. So which two factions took part in the first ever AEW Blood and Guts match?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh,
it wasn't that one. It was, they were named this.
I remember a terrible bump off the cage into some mats.
That may help you.
Oh, is that match?
I think it's that match, yeah.
Yeah, it's that match.
Question three. Which wrestler connects the following people? Solo Sikoa, LA Knight, or The Knight, Kenny Omega, Kunico, El Fantasmo.
Could you repeat that?
It connects please? Them all.
Which wrestler connects the following people? So people have this wrestler in common? Solo Sikoa, LA Knight, Kenny Omega, Kunico, and El Fantasmo.
Wait, no, it's not that one. It's the other one.
I'm really sorry. I'm going to ask you to say that again. Even though I'm not going to know it, but, you know, it'll make me look like I think I might know it. So, can you repeat that?
Which wrestler connects the following people? Solo Sikoa, LA Knight, Kenny Omega, Kunico, El Fantasmo.
Got it, yeah. I'm confident about that.
Question four. Current NXT superstar Brooks Jensen is a second-generation superstar whose father wrestled in a number of factions such as the Truth Commission in the USWA and WWF, RO&D, Roughly Obsessed and Destroy, in All Japan Pro Wrestling, Pro Wrestling Noah, and the member of one of the most hated stables of the Attitude Era. Who is he? I feel like Bent made these questions really long because he knows that I can't really speak very good.
He knows that I can't listen either.
They're definitely hard.
So that was current NXT superstar Brooks Jensen is a second generation superstar whose father wrestled in a number of factions such as the Truth Commission in the USWA and WWF, RO&D, Roughly Obsessed and Destroy in All Japan in Pro Wrestling and Pro Wrestling Noah, and was a member of one of the most hated stables of the Attitude Era. Who is he?
Do you have any questions on ICW from 2009 until 2015?
No.
I don't think so.
No, okay, cool.
If I could just list all the names of the people in the Truth Commission, I'd probably get it. So
yeah, good luck.
Should get there eventually. Question five.
I'm still there.
Question five. Actually, this one's going to change. This was generally just one, but I will give bonus points if you can name them. Making their start in ECW in the mid-90s, the tag team of Bubba Ray and Devon Dudley are arguably the most decorated tag team in professional wrestling. But how many official Dudley brothers were there in ECW?
And I got point for each name. Of course the deathmatch guy has fucking got this one. Fuck's sake.
I will give you a point for each name as well.
Oh, right, okay, that's fine. I'll need a while, though.
What? So
you'll get each a point. Name? You'll get a point if you can name how many. There's and you'll get a point per name you get as well. So yeah, the total, I can't tell you what the total is because I'll give away the...
We're not counting the two main brothers, though.
We're not... Hang on.
Not counting Bubba and Devon.
They're counting.
Counting yeah, as well. Sure they're counting.
So, yeah. Firstly, was that question
then count as bonus points for naming them all?
You get bonus. Yeah, so you're going to get two bonus points, surely, at least here.
Was that question five?
That was question five.
Okay, second part of that question was, are you trying to actively make me look bad?
I mean,
you can ask Grant Carter that question, not Billy.
I mean,
Did I ask you, Pipsqueak?
I don't give a shit, man. So.
That's a little bit better. That's the fight I want. That's better.
Everyone happy with that? Well, has everyone tolerated that? We'll move on.
Yeah, tolerated even being strong there, really.
Question six. What was the name of the group that was part of WWE SmackDown in 2017, whose members included Natalya, Carmella, Tamina, James Ellsworth, and Lana?
They had a name.
What the fuck was it?
That was the dark days.
That was the days when I didn't watch any WWE.
Yeah, because it was pish.
Yeah, exactly.
So what was the name of the group that was part of WWE SmackDown in 2017, whose members included Natalya, Carmella, Tamina, James Ellsworth, and Lana?
They had a fucking name.
I'll just put a comedy name down, why not?
Now, I hope that everyone gets question seven, because you should. On the January 29th, 2009 episode of TNA Impact, the Main Event Mafia took over the show. Scott Steiner provided ring introductions for the matches, and Kevin Nash and Booker T were the commentary team for the night. But what were the aliases that they used?
Oh, man.
What year was this?
2009.
The one time Sebastian Asher should be here.
He will not forgive me.
I'm speaking for Snake as well, but I didn't watch wrestling in 2009. So...
Oh shit, no, I remember it now, right? Okay, I've got it now, yeah.
So there is only one point on offer, so you have to get both names.
That was an excellent
episode.
Yeah. Oh yeah, mate.
I mean, it was a recent subject at OSW review, if anyone wants.
Yeah. Well. Booker T, never mind the ring. Commentating on yourself beating up somebody. I think it was Xavier Woods. He was beating up. Consequences Creed, he was beating up as well.
Yeah.
Laying the boots down.
So that was Reed again. On the January 29th, 2009 episode of TNA Impact, the Main Event Mafia took over the show. Scott Steiner provided ring introductions for the matches, and Kevin Nash and Booker T were the commentary team for the night. But what were the aliases that they used? Question eight.
Doing a very, very bad job of representing the women of Scottish wrestling right now. Like, I represent none of you because this is very hard.
That's because you're about to lose to me.
Well, really.
I mean, Tom will get his wooden spoon.
Don't let that happen.
Yeah, like, I've already set my address, so just
Billy, Billy, I'll give you a fiver to just, like, rig it so that I don't lose to that little thing. So
that little thing?
There's still plenty of points on offer. X Factor. Question 8. Question 8. X Factor debuted as a faction in WWF in 2001 and consisted of group leader X Pac, Just Incredible, and Albert. But what artist performed their entrance theme?
Yes. No. Oh, yeah. Culture. Culture up, right here on the quiz. Up the X Factor.
Someone from X Factor?
Wagner.
X Factor before there was an X Factor.
I applaud.
You say that as I'm writing down Simon Cowell.
I applaud Brent Carter for giving X Factor some love. Well done.
So that was
X Factor
debuted as a faction in WWF in 2001 and consisted of group leader X Pac, Just Incredible, and Albert. What was the artist perform? But what artist performed their entrance theme?
That's question eight.
It's question eight. Yeah. Question. Brent, you've written bloody essays here for these questions.
Of course he did.
Question nine. Before leaving WCW in 1999, Raven was part of a group called the Deadpool. Didn't realize that. Alongside the Insane Clown Posse and Vampiro. After his departure and the group's disbandment, Vampiro eventually brought the horror punk band The Misfits into WCW to accompany him, with bassist Jerry Only even competing in and emerging victorious in a steel cage match on Monday Nitro. Who was his opponent?
Oh, fuck.
That's a very good question. Fuck you, Brent.
When was this, sorry?
1999.
Oh, so it
wasn't even born.
Can I weren't born. This is unfair.
What company?
WCW.
He's somebody shite, probably, though. It's WCW 1999, but...
So I'll read that again, because I've got my breath back. Before leaving WCW in 1999, Raven was part of a group called the Deadpool, alongside the Insane Clown Posse and Vampiro. After his departure and the group's disbandment, Vampiro eventually brought the horror punk band The Misfits into WCW to accompany him, with bassist Jerry Only even competing in and emerging victorious in a steel cage match on Monday Nitro. Who was his opponent? Oh, sweet. Next question has actually got an answer for an episode I did recently. Wonderful. Right. Good. Cool.
Ooh.
It's not out yet, though, so it'd have to be a Patreon exclusive if you've heard it. Patreon.com/ScottResnet. £1.20.
Good cheap plug there. Good.
Cha-ching.
Question 10. So there's still five more after this. Question 10. In 2020, Retribution debuted in WWE. At the time, the leader of the stable, who was later revealed to be Mustafa Ali, was still unknown, and the group consisted of Dio Madden, Mace, Shane Thorne, Slapjack, Dominic Dijakovic, T-Bar, Mia Yim, Reckoning, and Mercedes Martinez, who was only part of the group for 2 weeks before requesting to leave the group and return to NXT. What name did she use whilst briefly being part of the group?
Sick.
What name did she use?
Yeah, what was her retribution name?
Don't
read out the question again, Billy. I feel bad for you having to say all that again. I'll get the bit at the end.
Billy, I'll give you this just in case for a few questions, yeah?
Just want to point out on this question, the DAPW lads have a group chat that used to be called the Slapjack Stan Society.
So surely you guys are going to get this.
But surprisingly, we won't.
can I just point out that it's pronounced Slapjack, for the record?
No.
I agree with Billy on this point, Patrick. I won't lie.
So I will try to just kind of break that down. Mercedes Martinez was part of Retribution. What was her Retribution name? Question 11. We're on the home straight, guys. TNA during 2013, Mr. Anderson became the second vice president of the Aces and Eights faction. The original vice president was demoted from his position as a punishment for losing an I Quit match against Kurt Angle. Can you name him?
Oh, yeah.
This was when I was watching TNA.
Unlucky for some.
Aces and Eights was good, man.
Were they?
Yeah.
Yeah. Banging theme song.
Yeah.
Do you need his TNA name specifically?
I love the massive retcon of like the last year of TV to try and make it make sense when the
I was kinda looking forward to at least one person agreeing with me and everyone was like, Yeah. I'm like, oh shit. I read that room wrong.
So
all for TNA.
That's a nice short question, so I can reread that. In TNA during 2013, Mr. Anderson became the second vice president of the Aces and Eights faction. The original VP was devoted from his position as a punishment for losing an I Quit match against Kurt Angle. Can you name him?
Wait, thanks. Shit.
Was that 11?
I was 11.
Right.
2 seconds.
I'm just losing track because of all the blank spaces I have. So, you know.
Question 12. In 2004, then WWE champion JBL assembled a group that he referred to as his cabinet.
Hey.
Here we go.
Well, we talk about far right. Here we fucking go.
The group consisted of Amy Weber as his image consultant, the Basham brothers as his co-secretaries of defense, Gillian Hall as his publicist, and Orlando Jordan. What position did Jordan hold whilst he was part of JBL's cabinet?
Hell yes.
There's been a wrestling cabinet before.
Yeah.
Oh, I was just asking.
Look, you brought the right of rights into this, Brody. Surely you've got this.
I don't think JBL's cabinet were necessarily.
Honestly, I have no answers but guns.
I mean,
so.
he did patrol the border and look for Mexicans.
I mean, that's just a bit of crack, though, wasn't it? You said a whole bunch of shit I don't understand.
That's just
a joke, right?
And technically, he was looking for the ones that were crossing illegally. The ones that are crossing legally, fine.
He did do that promo where he kicked somebody over the border, didn't he?
Yeah. And then wasn't he in Mexico and gave Eddie Guerrero's mum a heart attack by grabbing her? And literally gave her a heart attack.
Fantastic times, that. Fantastic.
Yeah.
So that was the
Godzilla. Remember that?
Ah, Godzilla. In 2004, when WWE Champion JBL assembled a group, that was an impression of an Austin Powers film, in case anyone thinks I went wildly racist there.
I absolutely got it, but man, that was this quiz is
all sorts of fucking cancelled now.
Did you know it's the guy in Grey's Anatomy that's like the big, no, in some sort of medical show, he's like supposed to be like cool and all that, but he's the guy who says, hey, it's Godzilla and Austin Powers. That's just... anyway, I got your pay laugh. I'll move on. In 2004, when WWE Champion JBL assembled a group that he referred to as Cabinet, the group consisted of Amy Weber as image consultant, the Basham Brothers as his co-secretaries of defense, Jillian Hall as his publicist, and Orlando Jordan. What position did Jordan hold whilst part of the Cabinet? Question 13. From 2009 to 2010, CM Punk was the leader of the Straight Edge Society, a group that consisted of... I'm not reading all these questions out again, but we go back to the answers, by the way.
That's fair.
Right. So from 2009 to 2010, CM Punk was the leader of Straight Edge Society, a group that included Luke Gallows, Joseph Mercury, and Serena. During an episode of SmackDown in 2010, security footage of Serena in a bar drinking alcohol with an unnamed man was shown as part of their ongoing storyline. The unknown man in question was played by which current wrestling superstar?
Yeah.
You literally started asking that question. I was like, fuck yes. Luke Gallows, Joey Mercury, Serena. Oh. Oh. I was so confident I would know that one. You really duped me, man.
I feel like that's how Brent wrote it. It wrote these questions to think, yeah, I know this is going to be.
This is Brent's round.
This is Brent's round.
Why, I'm going to kick his ass for this, man. Expecting me to know wrestling questions? Seriously?
Question. Do you want me to read that again?
No.
Who was
the unknown man? Who's the unknown man? In question.
I'll give you a clue. He's the current quizmaster, right? I think I'll say
he is currently injured, but he is a wrestling superstar.
Belly.
Personal opinion, I kind of feel like Patrick is starting to overstep his mark.
Only a little bit.
Because he's not a quizmaster, and he's starting to be like, well, I think I'll actually find Billy. Like, that's not. Like,
just wait for
I won't lie, Billy. For all the cheek he's giving you, maybe you should deduct a couple of points. I'm just putting it out there.
I'm just trying to get Billy to stay strong. He was staying strong right at the start, but we've been going for a while, and I think he's tiring a wee bit. Remember the power you have. Stick to your guns, mate.
Such a suck up, bro.
Question 14. According to original member Sawyer Fulton, the idea of Sanity Group was came from Triple H watching and being inspired by which 2006 film?
Stop it.
No, we'll continue.
Sanity. Fucking... Eric Young was in there?
Eric Young, Killian Dane, Atso.
Nicky Cross.
Alexander Wolf.
I always called him Atso Tisha.
So, according to the original member, Sarah Fulton, the idea for Sanity Group, from the Sanity Group, came from Triple H watching and being inspired by which 2006 film?
Are you Ring Camp rather than Imperium as well then, Tom?
I'm trying to just think of films 2006.
Honestly, Patrick, it's probably a bit of a... No!
It's Noel's birthday today.
Happy birthday, Noel! Yay!
Happy birthday.
Yeah. Oh, has your cat not been in a shit? Because mine's is. Yeah.
Sorry,
what was question 14?
According to original member Sarah Fulton, the idea for the Sanity Group came from Triple H watching and being inspired by which 2006 film?
What was the point in me asking?
I know. I don't know why, but
you've showed the cat. You're going to show the tortoise.
Okay, get the torch.
That's such a good idea. Hang on. 2 seconds.
Get all the pets on.
What filth have I descended into here? What?
At least it's not retro. Yeah.
Show me the tortoise.
Very aggressively asking.
So we've got one question.
I can't even think in my head like what gimmick Santa even had.
I've never seen this film, but clearly.
I'm thinking in my head, like, if somebody says it, I'll be like, all right, okay, but like, I can't think of that.
It's taken me almost to the end of this to notice that Patrick is wearing the SWN t-shirt six seasons and a Hello. T-shirt. So. Yeah.
There's Flash the Tortoise.
Hello, Flash.
You're not getting extra points for that.
Yeah.
I was waiting to say, is Flash you've got to chill on your desk?
No, he's going back to bed.
Okay.
So the final official question, we do have one bonus. Name the three members of the Prince Justice Brotherhood.
No.
You know what? I'll give you 3 points for it if you get for one for each. So name the three members of the Prince Justice Brotherhood.
My pen's now gone. I'm quite happy with my performance.
What is that? I don't know.
I am exactly. Really giving up.
I know the name. If you can give me a promotion as a clue, it'd be helpful, but I don't know.
TNA.
Okay, right, that's fine.
Jesus, I don't know that one.
You could have said Diamonds in the Rough for doing a better question.
Oh, Diamonds in the Rough for Ace. David Young being just like terrible, but like still cool at the same time.
Simon Diamond's there. You've always got a winner there.
Anyway. Felix Skipper. Anyway, yeah. So that's question 15. And we've got one final bonus essay. Of in 2011, after the Core injured his tag team partner, Vladimir Kozlov, Santino Marella formed a group called APPLE. To avenge his fallen friend.
Yeah.
The group only lasted for one night, and they were defeated in their 8-man tag team match against the Core on Raw. The group consisted of Santino and which 3 other wrestlers? 1 point for each correct answer, and 2 points for anyone that can correctly answer that what the acronym APPLE stood for. And that's all the questions.
I would need a year to get that right, but that's fine.
I am done. That is me. What I get is what I get.
So to remind people where we're at with the scores, Andrew is in the lead with 25. Patrick is nipping at his heels with 24.
We don't need to know who's where, thanks, Billy.
I think we do.
Spike is on 23, Brody on 18, and Tom coming up the rear of Brody with 16. And everyone ready for their answers?
Hang on, 2 seconds. I'm still doing my apple. Hang on.
Julie, just take 1 or 2 bites and you're fine.
Can I get points if I offer you cats?
No.
I'm allergic to cats, so that's probably working against you there.
Is it Billy, just for the record, is it 1 point for each like word you get right in apple, or do you have to get the whole thing right?
The whole thing.
Right, okay, cool. Oh, I won't get it then, but I know some of it.
Okay. So long ago, we were back at question one.
Yeah.
Who was the last wrestler? Who was the last wrestler to officially join the WCW/ECW alliance? It was Jazz.
Jazz.
Oh.
ECW.
So she joined. She joined the Survivor Series 2001, and less than 1 hour later, the alliance lost.
Spike.
We've lost Spike. We've lost Spike.
Nice build.
I mean, what was he really contributing? Come on.
He's been watching WWE 2001, and he's just really annoyed that you've spoiled Jazz showing up at Survivor Series.
He's been watching it in chronological order.
He's about where still goes up with Rodney Mack. I used to love him.
He's coming back.
Oh, was that... Did he not have the White Boy Challenge with Teddy Long?
Yeah. Fantastic.
Just making sure that Spike got that answer there.
Give him a second.
Did you get the answer for one?
Back. No.
Did you hear me tell you the answer for one?
No, I didn't hear it. I put it in Austin.
But... All right, it was Jazz. Question 2. Which 2 factions took part in the first ever AEW Blood and Guts match?
The Elite versus the Inner Circle.
It was Inner Circle versus the Pinnacle.
Yeah, boy!
Oh, it was the Pinnacle. Shit.
Yeah.
MGM that was Stadium Stampede, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Tiff, I wasn't too far off.
Yeah.
You forget the Pinnacle existed, though.
Alright, what was that? Wardlow, MGF, and FTR.
Wardlow, MGF, FTR.
And then Sean Spears.
Sean Spears.
Terrible stable apart from MGF.
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
Yeah. Which wrestler? Question three. Which wrestler connects the following people? Solo Sikoa, LA Knight, Kenny Omega, Hunico, and El Fantasmo.
New Japan's greatest striker of all time, Tanga Loa.
Camacho.
Point for both. Yes, yeah, same guy. So yeah. Tonga Loa or Camacho. Solo Sikoa, he's part of the Bloodline. LA Knight, they're both members of The Rising in TNA with Eli Drake and Drew Galloway.
Yeah.
Kenny Omega, they're both members of Bullet Club. Hunico, he teamed with as Camacho.
Yeah.
El Fantasmo, they're both members of the Guerrillas of Destiny. There you go. Tonga Loa. Question four, current NXT superstar is... current NXT superstar Brooks Jensen is second generation superstar. I'm not going to read the rest of it. Who is his dad?
Bill Buchanan.
Bill Buchanan, correct.
Oh,
cool. What about from B squared? Is that allowed?
Yeah. If you've got B squared, I'll take it.
Also part of the best stable of all time, The Right to Censor.
Yes. Best thing you recover as well.
In my head, I was like, who the fuck was in Right to Censor? But I can't mind any of them.
Stole the show at WrestleMania.
Good father, Bill Buchanan, Ivory, and Stevie Richards.
Yeah, Stephen Richards.
Yes.
The good father. Was Val Venus, was he in it? Do you see him?
Yeah.
Val Venus never changed his name for some reason in that. I don't know why.
Oh, good times.
Question five, making their start in ECW in the mid-90s, the tag team Bubba Ray and Devon Dudley are arguably the most decorated tag team in professional wrestling history. How many official Dudley brothers were there in ECW? And I will list out the names. There was Dudley Dudley, Snot Dudley, Big Dick Dudley, Dances with Dudley, Chubby Dudley, Sign Guy Dudley, Bubba Ray Dudley, Devon Dudley, and Little Spike Dudley. There were nine in total.
Okay.
We're not counting Joel Gertner as a Dudley boy? No.
No. But okay. Brent will also accept 11 if you counted Luke Dudley and Butch Dudley.
I was like, hey, that's one night.
Yeah. So, but if you said 11, he would have given you the point for it.
That's so, fine. Do you get individual points for each Dudley boy we named?
You get a point for 9 as the answer, and you get an additional point for every Dudley that you can name.
Cool.
Okay.
Question six. What was the name of the group that was part of WWE SmackDown in 2017, whose members included Natalya, Carmella, Tamina, James Ellsworth, and Lana? That sounds means that nobody's got it. It's the Welcoming Committee.
It was. I put the commission for some reason, but it wasn't.
I just put an Extreme Associates, but that's just an XPW thing.
I wrote cringe, but that's because I don't even know where I am anymore.
Question seven on the July, if not in July, but it's like 10:30. I'm well past my bedtime. On the January 29th, 2009 episode, TNA Impact, the Main Event Mafia took over the show. Scott Steiner provided ring introductions for the matches, and Kevin Nash and Booker T were the commentary team for the night. But what were the aliases that they used?
Chet Lemon and Black Snow.
That's correct. Chet Lemon and Black Snow.
Was this one point for both of them, yeah?
1 point, yeah, you have to get both names.
Yeah, cool, that's fine. That's fine.
It's just when Booker T comes back after he's done his beatdown, Kevin Nash is like, oh my god, it's Booker T.
Yeah.
It's like he's not seen him for the whole night.
Black Snow's gone. Oh my god, it's Booker T.
Question eight. X Factor debuted as a faction in WWF in 2001 and consisted of group leader X Pac, Just Incredible, and Albert. But what artist performed their entrance theme?
Uncle Cracker, baby.
Uncle Cracker, correct.
Yes.
Shut up.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, he did.
That's a banger of a song as well.
Yeah. I got everything I ever wanted.
I was waiting for that. You should have done a lot more with him. I liked X-Pac with like silver and blue and black gear.
Oh, yeah, I had that an action figure and it looked like ace. It was so cool. Not really helping with the old VL's comments from Brody earlier, but anyway. So to tear down this question, Jerry Only was in a match and emerged victorious in a steel cage match on Monday Nitro. Who was his opponent?
Hank Abbott.
Oh, you're close. It's Dr. Death Steve Williams.
Oh,
I'd say Dr. Death's better than Tank Abbott.
I meant like MMA tough guy kind of thing.
Okay.
Nobody's better than Tank Abbott.
He's the ultimate fighting champion.
Yeah.
He beat Pete Becker.
Do you know he beat Pete Becker?
To become the ultimate fighting champion. Yes.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's on his Wikipedia.
I wonder if he ever made it. I often think about that. Did Pete Becker make it?
Did Tank Abbott? Oh no, he was supposed to be I was going to be a world champion, but then that's when they decided
to once Russo was absolutely mental. World champion. They should have done that for Cuba.
Did he finish a match with a gun once? You know, made someone submit with a gun? Or am I just...
I think they were good. They were wanting to do a spot with a gun, but then he was against it.
No, that's how you finish an I Quit match.
That's it.
Hell yeah.
Right, I think that idea was very quickly shot down.
Right. And I got the joke.
Thank you, Billy. Thank you.
It was Tom said it. Oh no, that was shite. Right, anyway.
Look, should I just fuck off to the fridge then? All right, fine.
Yeah,
we're almost there.
He's finally figured it out.
Mercedes Martinez was part of Retribution. What was her Retribution name?
Sniper. No.
Retaliation. That's her name.
Jesus, give me strength.
How Mustafa Ali's recovered from that to X Division champion, I'll never understand.
Was it Sniper part of the Truth Commission?
Yes.
Have you seen him?
He's great, obviously, but just Jesus.
I think that's threw me off because he said about the Truth Commission. I was like, I'll just try and name names for the Truth Commission. One of them will be there.
At TNA during 2013, Mr. Anderson became the second vice president of Aces Eights faction. Who was the first?
D'Lo Brown.
Correct. D'Lo Brown.
Yes.
I put Wes Briscoe.
I don't even know what question we're on.
I believe Devon was the sergeant at arms.
There was a director of chaos. Luke
Gallows. Doc Gallows, yeah. Good times, man. Good times.
Question 12.
Nux.
2004, WWE champion JBL assembled his cabinet. What position did Orlando Jordan hold whilst part of the JBL's cabinet?
Manager of security?
Well, he was chief of staff.
I think Patrick's didn't do well in this round. I think
you've been watching a lot more of WWF and the WWE in 2004 than me.
Oh, that was like my properly getting into wrestling time. Was that Dick Cheney for Bush? Because the whole thing was obviously a thing.
He was meant to be George Bush.
So I'm pretty sure Dick Cheney was Bush's chief of staff. So I think that's where it came from.
Anyway,
early noughties politics.
No politics in wrestling. That's just.
Brody Adler, who's massively right-wing, as of this evening.
It's better than being political in wrestling, which is something I'm not. So,
13. So, Straight Edge Society, a group that consisted of Luke Gallows, Joseph Mercury, Serena. During an episode of SmackDown, security footage of Serena in a bar drinking alcohol with unnamed man was shown. Who was that unnamed man?
Adam Cole.
It was Adam Cole.
Yeah.
Adam Cole, I didn't even think he'd be having a drink.
Yeah, man.
Fucking hell.
Yeah, baby.
Absolute ranging.
14. According to the original member Sawyer Fulton, the idea for the Sanity Group came from Triple H watching and being inspired by which 2006 film? The answer, apparently, is Smoking Aces.
Oh. That'd be better for Aces and Eights. Surely that's inspiration for them.
15. So the last official question. Name the three members.
Question 15?
Yeah, there's one afterwards as well. Name the three members of Prince Justice Brotherhood.
Does it even matter then, does it?
I just put who the fuck?
Eric Young? No?
I'll give you it. Super Eric.
Yes.
Super Eric. All right, okay. So
if there's a TNA faction, just guess Eric Young because he was probably in it.
So Super Eric. Jay Lethal and Apollo Creed?
It was Super Eric, Shark Boy, and Curry Man.
Yes! Oh, in there!
God's sake.
Get him.
Finally, in 2011, after the Core injured his tag team partner Vladimir Kozlov, Santi Morella formed a group called APPLE, Apple, and to avenge his fallen friend. It consisted of Santino and which three other wrestlers? We'll start with that bit first.
Yeah.
And we'll take a crack at it.
I guessed Mark Henry, Evan Bourne, and Daniel Bryan.
Correct.
Yeah. Oh, you got them all. I guess Evan Bourne, and I didn't have for the other two ones.
And do you want to take a crack at what Apple stood
yes.
for?
Can I solve the puzzle? Very Wheel of Fortune style. Was it angry people powered by loathing everything that you stand for?
Oh, you're so close.
Jesus Christ.
It is allied people powered by loathing everything that you stand for.
I'm going
to get
a point for that.
You might as well give it.
Nah. I'm happy that I got that close. Allied people.
So, I'll give you all a moment to total up your scores, and we'll find out who's won.
Billy, personally, Billy, I don't know if I even have the mathematical genius to tally up how many scores I have.
So are you saying I get a point for every Dudley boy, and I get a point for getting it right?
You get a point for getting 9 for all the Dudley boys, yeah. And you get a point. Right. You get a bonus point for each Dudley boy you can name.
Okay, that's fine.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
So for the final time, Andrew.
14.
14. Patrick. Sorry, Brody.
I mean, Billy, what even is a point? Right? What is why do we need to count points in life? Why do we depend on having points?
So 0.
I got 2, right?
Did you get both Dudleys?
Yes.
You didn't even get Spike.
Yes, no, I didn't.
He sat right fucking here.
Patrick.
I'm just double checking, sorry, to make sure I've got it right. 1, 2.
Be like 20 or something.
6, 7, 8.
Right, Patrick, that's 9, plenty. 10, just say 20, the number, 20. Right? That's not fair. That's like 20.
Yeah, 20, spot on, 20.
Absolute shit.
Spike.
10.
And Tom.
4.
Oh no, Tom.
Billy, I don't care where I come in this whole mad shenanigan thing, right? Please tell me I'm at least above Tom.
Not even.
I mean, if my math is right, these are joy.
Yeah,
that's... Oh, but Tom's got the fucking 3 fake points, so you know.
But there's no points.
They're not points.
We agree to them.
I know, baby. It's not fair.
Me and the quizmaster agree to them.
So, in first place... Actually, I'll go back. In joint last is Tom Atlas with 20 points and Brody Adler with 20 points. So, Tom, if he didn't have those 3 points, would have ended up last.
I'm taking it for what it is.
Can I just state a case here as well, right? If me and Tom are drawn and he got 3 extra points. Fuck you.
You're in the same level as me, so fuck you.
Next
Wait,
up.
You
in third place is Spike Tierney with 33 points. Andrew Crammond next in second place with 39 points. And that means the winner with 44 points is Patrick Patirski.
Get
him. He didn't need that extra point.
Get him.
You must have bagged your wife early. Dutch, please leave me alone. you must have bagged your wife early because, wow.
So that's it. Lucky 5 lady. Rounds. We have been here for ages. 5 rounds of questions. How has everyone felt about the quiz? Were you always, other than not being happy with the wins?
I mean, depressed, but...
I had a great time.
Fine.
Shut up, Patrick, you and your one eye. You can leave.
If there was more horror movie questions than ECW questions, it would be a lot better. But
yeah, can we make that a suggestion for next year, please?
And, can you please ask more questions on the Cornetto trilogy next time?
Oh, yeah, I agree. Cornetto
trilogy. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And returning to the podcast to congratulate the winner, Mr. Ian Skinner.
Takeaway is 2 points. Take it away.
I hate to sound like a hypocrite, but have you dyed your hair?
What? Huh?
Natural colour. So yes, this has been the Day of Birth Bonanza, number 4 in the books.
Skinner. In the pocket, out of sight.
Billy, are you still wanting to genuinely send me a wooden spoon since I still technically came last?
Half a wooden spoon, actually.
So my t-shirt says Alan. It looks like the alien logo, and it says, in space, nobody can hear you in space.
You should have had more questions about Alien, Billy. That would have been
yes, absolutely. Considering I just considering I beat the game, yeah.
Tom Atlas would have won the quiz if we had more questions about Alien, because he is a xenophobe.
Wait, whoa. This podcast has been controversial enough, okay?
We've already established
let's go to an ad break. Tory.
I feel
let's go to an ad break. We'll keep it right here.
We already established Brody was a Tory. So we've had an exciting edition.
That's a true fact, folks. Google it.
Brody Adler, Tory.
Joke's on you. Nobody knows who I am. I am not on Google.
And hold on, Skinner. You were in fact who's cabinet.
Why do you look so small?
Because I am, okay?
What happened? Why did we get Turbo Tom Iron?
Skinner, what have you been doing this whole time? Are you pre-recorded, or are you like, have you just been like filling this time with whatever like activities you feel are appropriate?
Activities such as?
I'm just back from download, dude. You don't want to know the pattern that's going
I was going to start a list there, but let's not keep this episode going any longer. Billy, take us out.
This has been the day of birth.
And by take us out, I mean Tom Atlas with a sniper rifle.
Please, I'm begging you.
This has been the Birth Bonanza. Happy birthday to me. I know nobody said happy birthday to me in this episode. So
happy birthday, Billy.
Oh, no, it's too late now. But this
your birthday sucked, personally.
Thank you for taking part.
This.
Congratulations, Billy, Patrick.
Billy, it's not your shoot birthday.
Yeah, hold on. Yeah.
All right, I'll be waiting at my Facebook wall then for
when can I brag about this on the FCW podcast then?
I just can't wait to see Skinner at 3 a.m. personally. Like,
all you have to do is just wake up with sleep paralysis, and that's what happens.
Yeah, I've been there.
I knew that's what that was.
So, trophy will be on its way to you soon, Patrick. And by the time you should have it by 9 p.m.
Does he get the belt?
July 2nd. No, I didn't get the belt back. So, and that was the year round. That was year one prize. So he gets a nice trophy, which I have.
No, dude. One of the rounds should have been going to Brent's house and battering him for that belt, and I would have absolutely won.
You'll get 20 points if you go do it. You'll still finish second. Right. So,
Billy, give her 20 points.
Wait!
We're still recording, Billy.
Yeah, no, we need to go. This has been the Day of Birth Bonanza. Yeah, because you're a child. Right, okay. Exactly. This has been the Day of Birth of Bonanza. Thank you very much to everyone who got involved. Thank you to everyone who did the quiz rounds. Brent Carter, Grant McIver, Kelly, Mrs. SWN, and of course, Ian Skinner as well. This has been a fantastic long show. Thank you very much for joining us. Good night.
Right, back to the fridge.
Second space, yes. Skinner approach.
2nd Space Day of Birth Bonanza champion is none other than yours truly, Patrick Paterski. I've just got home from my shoot job, and I've come home to a lovely parcel from the one and only Billy Strachan. And let's have a look and see what this wee note says, that for some reason is on Spider-Man paper. Ask anyone at FCW, I famously know hee-haw and care not for superheroes, but we move. Dear Mr. Paterski, also known as Mr. Day of Birth Bonanza, I may ask Stevie Wizard to put that as my new prefix, but here we go.
I'm sure you'll love that. Congratulations on your epic win. Please find and close an epic trophy to celebrate such a battle. Until next year, Billy. Thank you very much, Billy. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is what I have won. I am genuinely, genuinely buzzing because it looks class. It's a lovely wee trophy and it will go nicely on my YouTube shelf there behind me. Now, there will be people that will say that the only reason that I won this year was because a Mr. Fair City Hooligan and Mr. Brent Carter was not involved in the competition. I can't help that he wasn't there. All I can say is, let's see who the better man is next year, Brent. Until then, get yourself along to Fair City Wrestling shows to see me and my tag partner, Ken Douglas, hopefully get some much-needed revenge on Redgate. And we'll see what the future holds for us. So keep watching SWN, get subscribed to his YouTube, get on the podcast feed on Spotify, and yeah, until next time. Oh, and check out the FCW podcast as well. I should probably plug my own show on the network. But yeah, thanks again, Billy. Thanks again to everyone that was involved with the quiz. It was a really fun night. And aye, see you after.
So after a long day at work, I came home to a delivery. Now, I've not fully opened it. I just want to see, you know, if it opens well. So let's see what I've been delivering, shall we? Billy, you're not funny. I'm coming back next year and going to win. Understand? Good. Take your wooden spoon and go shove it up your